FIVEAA.
South Australia is set for an economic boom with China about to remove its crippling tariffs on wine. A final decision is expected in late March, after Australia reached an agreement with China late last year to work towards ditching the duties placed on Australian wine in 2021. Wine critic Ray Jordan says the industry's been struggling since then.
There's an awful lot of wine sitting in tanks, especially in South Australia, which is the country's biggest wine-producing state. And a lot of it is, well, it's sitting there in tank. It's all gassed up. It's not going to go off. But, boy, there's a lot of wine to start moving very quickly.
A report is being prepared for the coroner after a death at a southern suburbs beach. Mel Usher has the details.
An elderly man has died in a suspected drowning at Aldinga Beach. A group pulled him from the water around 3 yesterday afternoon, but he couldn't be saved. The scene playing out in front of the 79-year-old's wife, they had just celebrated 60 years of marriage. Police say there are no suspicious circumstances.
There'll be a court appearance today for cyclist Rowan Dennis. The 33-year-old has been charged with causing death by dangerous driving, as well as one count of driving without due care. It's alleged he was behind the wheel when his 32-year-old wife Melissa was struck down outside their Medindi home on December 30 last year. He's been on police bail caring for their two young children. It's unclear what started a house fire in the northern suburbs last night. The alarm was raised at Albert Street in Kilburn just before 8:30. Crystal Mitchell from the MFS says it took 20 minutes to extinguish the blaze.
The ceiling has fallen in and the house has suffered significant amount of damage.
A UK arrest warrant has been handed to Andrew Tate as he languishes in a custody in Romania, where he's accused of rape and human trafficking, reportedly dating back more than a decade. The controversial internet personality is wanted for other alleged crimes in Britain. A Bucharest court will make the final decision about whether to hand the 37-year-old to UK authorities. And the Commonwealth Bank has experienced a nationwide online outage, although services are returning to normal. CommBank warns that some payments may still be delayed. Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Gliderol Garage Doors, adding strength, style and safety to your home. Gliderol.com.au.
Here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Graeme. Adelaide forward Taylor Walker faces a fitness test this morning ahead of the Crows' season opener on Saturday night against Gold Coast. Walker has been battling some back issues, but he is expected to play. Port's players will also train this morning ahead of Sunday's clash against West Coast at home. Meantime, Melbourne star Christian Petrarca has described Clayton Oliver as an inspiration after working his way back into the senior side. There were significant doubts over whether Oliver would play in the opening round amid personal issues and concerns about his behaviour. Petrarca telling Fox Footy he lost trust in Oliver but has since forgiven him.
The thing that I've learnt over the last 7 or 8 weeks is the power of forgiveness. People are going to make mistakes. We're human beings. Like, it's just going to happen. And I think from that point of view, the ability to understand what Clayton's going through, how can we help him? What can he lean on us to help him with those situations?
To cricket in South Australia is on top, heading into day 3 of its Shield clash against Tasmania in Hobart. The Redbacks were dismissed for only 175 in their second innings, but it's still given them a significant lead of 323 runs. And the Tigers lost star batsman Matthew Wade late in the day to finish at 1-for-8 in their second innings. And European Champions League action is on again for another morning, with Arsenal hosting Porto and needing to overturn a 1-0 loss in the opening leg, while Barcelona faces Napoli in the other match. And that's the 5AA Sport.
And now the 5AA Forecast.
No better time or place to jump in a Jayco than at Jayco Adelaide's brand new West Beach dealership.
Partly cloudy and 33 today. Tomorrow a late shower or two, 28. Friday a possible shower and 28. And Saturday mostly sunny, 31. Right now it's 24. More news as it happens on 5AA.
It's Edward from Edwardstown Mazda. The M&Vent is on now. It's really big. So here's a big person to tell you more.
Thanks, Edward. He's right. Our once-a-year M&Vent is on now and it's big.
How big?
Think huge M&Vent factory bonuses plus a $2,000 trade-in bonus exclusive to Edwardstown Mazda.
Wow.
I know. The M&Vent on now.
Now play that jingle thing, please.
It's gotta be.
Edwardstown Mazda.
Hi, I'm Lynn Andrews. The Lynn Andrews team have seen a lot of change in real estate over the past 50 years, but one thing remains unchanged: our passion to help people invest in their future. To build strong property portfolios in either the residential or the commercial sectors. Our commitment to property investment over the years means we have a wealth of knowledge to share. We're here to help you. Visit lynandrews.com.au.
At Lordman & Pank, we offer a wide range of premium Essilor lenses to meet your individual needs. Shop today for $150 off selected digital progressive lenses. Offer ends April 3. T's and C's apply. See website for details. Lordman & Pank, we care for eyes.
More than 17,000 Australians, both young and old, will die from stroke or heart attack caused by hypertension or high blood pressure this coming year. Many could be prevented through early detection. But right now, an Adelaide research team is seeking volunteers for a study to trial a potential treatment. If you've been diagnosed with moderate hypertension and you're between 18 and 72, you could be eligible. Go to fusiontrials.com.au/hypertension or call 08 7077 6996. You will be compensated for your time.
The BMW sale event starts this Thursday. Enjoy savings equal to the GST on select BMW vehicles across the range. Visit your participating BMW dealer today. Terms and conditions apply. Offer ends 18th of March 2024.
In Adelaide and across South Australia, this is 5AA. Always Adelaide.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on. Touch base. Search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
Right on, 8 minutes after six. Good morning to you. Welcome to Wednesday on 5AA Breakfast. It is the 13th of March, being a Wednesday. We're going to go around the courts with Sean Fuster after 7:30 today. David Kosh will join us. A lot of interesting money news that's developed since last we spoke with Koshy that might frame the RBA's decision-making for the rest of the year. So we'll get an updated view from Koshy on when and if we can expect an interest rate cut at some point this year. Also over the course of the morning, a return of Australian wine to China. Big news that broke shortly after the TV news finished last night that we'll be talking about over the course of the morning today. And also, Jade Robren is on deck and out and about roaming the streets of Adelaide, covering all the things that develop right across the morning. David Penberthy, good morning to you.
Good morning, Will. Good morning, listeners. It's so nice to wake up to an unadorned positive news story, given that South Australia was the absolute epicentre of the economic and human impact, because, you know, businesses are, at the end of the day, all about people. These absurd wine tariffs that were brought in purely in retaliation after the people of Beijing, the government of Beijing, rather, took umbrage at former PM's call, Scott Morrison's call for an investigation into the origins of COVID. Next thing you know, Charles Melton, Darrenberg, Sepultsfield, the list goes on. Wineries in Langhorn Creek that had sprung up overnight in the last 20 years purely to service growing Chinese demand for red wine. Some of them probably haven't even emerged the other side, you would think. There's one near me on Green Hill Road that I always drive past thinking, I've never heard of this winery. I've never seen this wine in the shops.
Might be export only. My favourite stat about this was in the Tyser this morning. So China was the state's largest export market, unsurprisingly. So if you go back before the tariffs came in, the total value in October 2020, $946.5 million. It was about nearly 50% of all wine exports from South Australia went to China. As of November last year, with the tariffs well and truly in place, the value of that market became $2.7 million.
Jeez, it's staggering, isn't it?
How many jobs is that?
Yeah.
Look, forget the profitability of wineries. How many people out there picking grapes is that? How many people is that working in cellar doors?
Well, we did that.
Packaging.
We did that breaking at 8 only, was it last week, about the grape growers? I know there's all sorts of pressures on them for different reasons, one of which is just too many plantings of the same kind 30-odd years ago. But, you know, China coming on top of that is sort of the extra foot on their throat that they didn't need.
And I wonder too if a byproduct of this, as stressful as I'm sure the period's been, we've heard so many good stories about wineries that have diversified into other countries, the United States and South America or other countries in Europe that historically haven't been strong for Australian wine exports. I wonder if it means now you can be a bit more picky with your price point doing exports. So it's nice having China back, but we've got a sustainable business model now. If you want to reacquaint yourself with Australian wine and take the share that you had beforehand, it's now going to cost you 15% more.
Yeah.
Or 10% more, or 5%, whatever it might well be, because
a lot of the wineries now have managed to find a way to survive without it.
Yeah.
Which means you've got a lot, you've suddenly got a billion more customers.
Mm.
That can only be a good thing for the profitability of your business.
I think, though, it's probably been a bitter learning experience for a lot of wineries where, I mean, some of them were exporting like 70% of what they sold in China.
But they were
so reliant on it. And
Who wouldn't? I reckon if any major Australian export industry suddenly lost China, they'd all learn a hard lesson. Like, I don't think wine was unique.
Oh, no.
If China banned iron ore, our whole country would grind to a halt.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, like...
But I think
yes.
Once bitten and massively bitten,
yeah,
I think they might think long and hard about going headlong down the, you know, putting all their eggs in the China basket. Mm.
It might have made the industry stronger in the long run.
If you're up and about stomping on a vat full of Cabernet in the Coonawarra or some Riesling grapes up in Clare, Seven Hill, give us a call. How has it affected any of our listeners who work in the wine industry?
Given the news broke at around 7 o'clock last night, I suspect many of them won't have gone to bed yet. They might still be up celebrating.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And any excuse will do for people in the wine industry.
That's right. It's all research, isn't it?
What's that great line from Sideways? What's the best day to open this bottle of wine? That wasn't from Sideways. It was Taras Achota from Achota Barrels. Mm. I heard him say once, someone said, what's the best day to open this bottle of wine? And he said, today.
Yeah.
And then you buy another one.
Yeah. Yeah. Wine people are a little bit less precious about
keeping
it for the special occasion.
He said, that's the line from Sideways. When you open this wine, it is a special occasion.
Yeah, that's right. 13 minutes after six. Our number this morning, as always, 8223-0000. You can shoot us a text on the Dutton's text line or jump on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream. We'll get to some news headlines next.
The new gen Mitsubishi Triton has landed. Strong, muscular styling. A sleeker, bigger interior with 9-inch touchscreen audio. 150 kilowatts of raw power from a 2.4-litre bi-turbo diesel. And a restless sense of adventure. The wild new gen Mitsubishi Triton is out there. Visit your local Mitsubishi Motors dealership to book a test drive today. Nothing can contain, tame or frighten a Mitsubishi Triton.
2 in 3 Aussies will be diagnosed with skin cancer. Cover things up, they last longer. Same goes for you.
If we're heading out for the day, it's usually quite early before the sun gets too nasty. Try to get the sunscreen on a good half hour beforehand and get their little rashies and whatnot on and the hats going into the water. Make it last for a couple of hours at least, and then, yeah, once we're all done and dusted, head inside. The worst part of the day, get out of the real heat.
I went and seen a friend and I noticed a friend had some stuff cut out and I thought, geez, I've never had anything cut out. I better go get checked. And luckily I did because they found melanoma, and if they had waited another 6 months, I might have been in a bit of trouble. So they've cut all the stuff out and I'm on the road to recovery. Now I wear a hat and sunscreen and all that stuff. Previously I wasn't really aware and I didn't take much notice of stuff. So yeah, now big difference now.
Slip, slop, slap, seek, slide and download the SunSmart app today. A message from Cancer Council SA and the Government of South Australia.
At the brand new Kent Town Hotel, there's room for everyone. The Kent Bar oozes with happy times and has outdoor seating undercover for over 150 people, while upstairs, the balcony bar has another 150 seats inside and out, and there's always the pool room for that party of 30.
Now, Will and I have been there. You've got to see the redevelopment to believe it. Tom, the owner, he knows hotels. He's been in them all his life, and he knows how to make your experience memorable, like the stunning 90-seat restaurant that opens fully to the street, where you'll find oysters open French style and more than 400 wines to choose from.
It's really unbelievable what they've done there, and it's little wonder they won the Best Hotel Redevelopment Award.
Yeah, that wine room alone is stunning, and all the cabinetry, the timber work is absolutely superb. Beautiful atmosphere. The Kent Down Hotel, everyone is loving this pub. We're the
boys from the bush. Lee Koenigan's new tour, Boys from the Bush, the concert, is heading to Adelaide for one night only at the Hightley Street Music Hall on Friday, 19th April. Lee will perform all the hits and all your favourites in a spectacular new production that features his hot new band. Don't miss Australia's own country music legend, Lee Koenigan, and his special guests at the Hindley Street Music Hall on Friday, 19th April. Book now on ticketmaster.com.au.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on. Touch base. Search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
16 after 6, bumped into a very excited Tom Wren in the hallway a few moments ago. He's got his top eight prepared, his Brownlow tip, his common medal tip.
That's why I wasn't talking to you during the ad break.
You're working on yours?
Oh, I've got it written here.
Yeah.
Not confident.
No, I didn't feel great about it. No. I think it's tough this year.
It feels like there's a whole bunch of sides that might be rubbish all year.
Yeah. I think picking your top eight is a question about 10 teams. And which two you leave out. That's how I felt about it. Anyway, we'll talk about it with Rennie in a moment. The Chinese Ministry of Commerce has released a draft proposal to lift its crippling tariffs on Australian wine. As we've been talking about this morning, it is doubtless the lead story here in South Australia today. It could mean an extra $1 billion for the local industry if the plan goes through later this month. As you've heard in 5AA News across the morning, and I wonder how many listeners we've had that were affected by this, given the timing of it, I imagine few, but maybe you were. The Commonwealth Bank had a nationwide outage. It appears that services are returning to normal. If you've seen anything that runs counter to that, we'd love to hear from you on 8223 0000. The issue appears to have affected NetBank, as well as people wanting to check their balances or make payments electronically. The issue, according to the bank, has been fixed, but some payments may be delayed, which would be a nuisance for normal people. But I imagine if you're on a small business and rely on it, it's potentially problematic, things not getting squared away overnight. So if that's you, again, let us know, because sometimes they report
things
these
on payroll
things.
Too.
That's right. Sometimes they say these things are fixed, and maybe technically they're fixed, but in terms of an operational sense, it can still take some time to play out. And if that's your experience, do give us a buzz. There's going to be a court appearance today for cyclist Rowan Dennis, the 33-year-old charged with causing death by dangerous driving, as well as one count of driving without due care. It is alleged he was behind the wheel when his 32-year-old wife, Melissa, was struck down outside their Medindie home on the 30th of December last year. He's been on police bail caring for their two young children. That'll be a big story as it develops over the course of the day.
I couldn't believe that. So that was the day our holiday had started, and I landed in the States and was reading it. My God.
Mm.
Shocking.
And the detail has been scarce,
yeah.
So we'll learn a bit more potentially today.
Yeah.
An abandoned home in Smithfield Plains is making headlines. It was once owned by Mark Hayden, the Snowtown accomplice, who's due for release sometime in May. It's been empty now for more than 20 years, and these neighbours spoke to Nine News and said it's time for the property to be demolished.
Take the bad memory down.
Knock it to the ground.
Yep, take the bad memory down.
And that house should be bulldozed and made as like a little memorial park or something.
It is creepy that it's still there. Who owns it?
Apparently someone bought it and never moved in.
Really?
And so...
What? As an investment property?
Jeez. Thought they'd get it cheap. Well, it looks like an abandoned hoarder home. It's all overgrown. There's rubbish everywhere.
Well, I think four of the murders happened there, didn't they?
Yeah.
Well, if the person who owns it was going to sell it, here we go. I was trying to call this up. I was looking at it the other day. This is so creepy. I wrote this feature for The Oz about Hayden and whether he's going to be released or not. And as part of it, I had a look at 30 Railway East Terrace, Snowtown. Now, we all know what was there. Well, it was sold on 27th of September 2012. And just reading the real estate agent's description of it. Here we go. For sale, a solid brick four-bedroom home with one bathroom, an attached shop, ex-bank building, including vault with lockable vault door. The home originally built as the bank manager's residence consists of four good-sized bedrooms, large eat-in kitchen, and separate dining and lounge area, bathroom with separate toilet. The old bank building was originally operated by the State Bank and sold in approximately 1995. It has since been used as a rental for commercial purposes, and more recently as a band room and setting for the movie Snowtown.
Oh, right.
Now, when you get to the bottom of it, there's a little asterisk. And for the uninitiated, for anyone who's been living under a rock, it says, buyers should note that illegal activities were conducted in the old bank building and you should inquire to the nature of these activities prior to bidding.
I like the idea that references the movie about Snowtown.
Yeah.
No, literally Snowtown happened here.
Like, it's just bizarre, isn't it?
Now, that's the power of omission, that entire opening three parts,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah. So see this movie. What was it about?
Yeah, how cool. Is it when the movies came to Snowtown.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. What was it, like a rom-com? You know,
mind
slapstick?
You, what do you do with that? That well, as a real estate agent.
The same thing applies with this joint, doesn't it?
Yeah, yeah, completely. Well, bulldoze it. I'm with the local residents.
So am I.
Bulldoze it. It's ridiculous.
Well, I mean, that you know, these poor people who were preyed upon, you know, and almost picked deliberately thinking that we can get away with it because they've got problems, they're itinerant, they've disappeared before. You know, they should be remembered properly.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's terrible.
All right, let's have a look at the weather today. A top of 32 expected to be cloudy, so won't be the sort of pretty hot day that we've come accustomed to over the course of the last week. The UV index still 10, which is considered very high. When the UV is 3 and above, cover up, use sun protection, stay sun smart, and download the Sun Smart app. For the rest of the week, how about this? Thursday, 28, late shower or two. That said, the headline kind of belies the actual picture. 50% chance of any rain up to a mil. But that would be welcome on Thursday.
One mil.
Potentially on Friday as well, 0 to 1, chance of any rain at 40%. So maybe between the 2 days, we might pick up a mil. Friday expected to reach a top of 28 as well. Cloudy for the next 3 days. Then by the weekend, it starts to the sun starts to come out and it warms up again. 31 on Saturday and mostly sunny. Just purely sunny on Sunday, 33. That'll be nice for the Port game. Monday, 33. And Tuesday, back to a very reasonable and comfortable 29.
Nice weekend again. We're getting a lot of messages on the Dutton's text line about China reinstating trade with Australia. Andrew says if Scott Morrison hadn't been grandstanding like the president of some superpower, none of this fiasco would have happened. And Chris says, happy for all the businesses that tariffs have been lifted. We can talk jobs and money, but let's not forget there are some serious human rights issues involved. As a country, are we happy to accept that? It's a fair question, but I think the answer is yes.
I think it's been asked and answered.
Yeah. I mean, as harsh as that might sound in the eyes of some people, I don't know. Is it the job of Chalk Hill Winery to be taking a stand in memory of June 4, 1989?
Well, it's been a big...
Tiananmen Square?
Forget wine. It's our biggest export market across every industry in Australia. I mean, the question is, what level of quality of life hit are you willing to take to make a stand?
Mm.
Because it affects the budget bottom line. It affects the way we fund healthcare.
Yeah.
But literally, this is the life... Exporting stuff to China is a large reason we enjoy the quality of life that we do in Australia.
Yeah, exactly. Hey, some questions too. What's this mean for wheat, barley, lobsters? I'm going to try to have a chat to Don Farrell, the Trade Minister, over the next hour or so.
It can only mean good things,
I think. Yeah, I think it will. Mm. Yeah, but we'll get some clarity from the Trade Minister around that.
All right. It's the moment you've all been waiting for. Tom Wren's in the 5AA Breakfast Studio. Colours, custom design, any house, any style. Glider or garage doors, gliderol.com.au. Morning to you, Rennie.
Morning, Will. Morning, David. Now, boys, I see you've done your homework, so big tick for you for both doing that. We've got our top 8 predictions and our other little exotics for the year. So I'll start, shall I? And you guys then tell me perhaps how you're looking. Top 8, I have gone the same as last season except for 2 changes. I've got Melbourne and St Kilda dropping out. And I think Melbourne, just based off what I saw last week, I've got the Crows and the Bulldogs coming in.
I have exactly the same top 8.
I've got
That's really, a good sign.
All right, well, grand final, I've gone with Brisbane versus GWS. Brisbane, I'm prepared to forgive them one game last week, albeit that's a bad second half fade out, and I've got GWS making the grand final as well.
You go, Will.
I like that. Well, I had the exact same top 8. As to who plays off in the grand final, GWS just feels so trendy. The way they ended last year, the talent in that side, is it too soon? Can they win 2 finals, top 4? I'm not willing to write Collingwood off yet. I'm going to say it's a Collingwood Carlton grand final.
Ooh, that would be huge. Oh,
seriously?
Mm.
I'm not going to watch that one. I'm going for same as you, Tom, GWS and Brisbane. Then I've got Carlton, Collingwood, Gold Coast in my 8.
You've got Gold Coast, yeah.
Yeah, I've got Gold Coast in there. Port coming 6th, Sydney coming 7th, and the Crows with 0 confidence. But I've got them 8.
So you've got the Suns and the Crows. So you've got the Suns instead of the Dogs.
I got no Melbourne.
No Bulldogs.
Melbourne are a basket case, I reckon. There's too much weird stuff going on there. Geelong are too old.
Yep.
The Saints, I don't even know how they got into the eight last year. They won all those silly games that no one was watching early in the year and had enough points to stay there.
Ross Lyon was coach of the year, I think, is how the Saints made it in.
And Bulldogs, I reckon the big story this year is going to be that they've sacked their coach.
Yeah, it could, if they don't, I think that will happen. Mm. Yep.
Definitely on the cards.
Spoon, I've gone for probably West Coast, but the one that I think could is Richmond. I think they're in real trouble.
Really?
I think it's a full reset for Richmond.
Yeah. I don't think anyone's as bad as West Coast.
Yeah.
They my second half of the year, there's talent there. Harley Reid looks like a freak. I think they'll Oscar Allen's obviously an elite tall forward. I think they'll start showing something by the end of the year, but I think their first half of this year is going to look awfully like last year for West Coast, and there'll be no coming back from there.
Yeah, it's surprising.
Did neither of you guys have Gold Coast in your own?
No.
Well, Quentin, the only person that Quentin, our mad son's listener, is happy with at the moment is me.
Yeah.
I would scarily good the other day.
I would love to see them in.
I don't think the Crows are going to win up there.
My only issue is
you guys tipping the Crows, round one?
I think it's a coin flip, that game.
Yeah, same.
Yeah.
I think they're a huge chance. I was very impressed with Gold Coast, but my only caveat to that is they played Richmond. And I, like I just said, I think Richmond are in a world of pain this season.
I hope Gold Coast are good. It'd be great if they made
the eight. I think it'd be superb
if they made the eight. It'd be terrific if they made the eight.
They've never made the eight, have they?
No.
They almost did when Gary Ablett was playing there.
Yeah.
They came ninth or something.
A couple of times they've sort of pushed, but every time they get close, they then fall away.
It'll be the biggest thing since Woodville finally made the five.
Brownlow, I've gone for a bit of a smoky, but I think the Crows captain, Jordan Dawson, might win it this year.
Well, really? He came top 10 last year,
didn't
he?
That's right. He's already a vote getter. They'll win more games, and I think he's eminently watchable. And he's in the umpire's eye line the whole time. I think he's a massive chance.
Yeah. I'll be stunned if he plays 22 games and doesn't win it, Nick Dacos. I think the umpires get caught up in the hype. Saying that, he's a wonderful footballer. He's incredibly...
Yeah.
But last year, he got votes every time he got, you know, a handball received, that bloke.
Yeah, he did.
It would blow my mind if he doesn't win one this year, it'll be next year. Yeah. Sometime soon.
Yeah, it's a really good call. They love the romance. They fall in love.
That's right. He's a great story. Yep. And he's a magnificent footballer to watch.
Yeah.
But
you're right.
Some blokes just catch the umpire's eye, and he's clearly one.
I didn't do a Brownlow guy, sorry.
No, that's all right. Have a think about that. Rising
the
star.
The dog ate it.
Harley Reid's probably the one. I've gone with Wardlaw from North Melbourne.
Okay.
And I've stuck with the North Melbourne theme for the Coleman. I think Nick Larkey's a hell of a player. I think if they can win a few more games, I've actually gone with him for the...
I hope so. Yeah, that'd be good. I like Nick Larkey. He kicked bags when they were getting smashed last year. But he kicked 70-odd goals.
He's a really good player. But again, there's some, you know, Alistair Clarkson, who knows what's going on there. There seems to be a bit bubbling along. So North Melbourne are a fascinating watch for me this season.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how they go.
Yeah. I don't think they'll go anywhere near the top eight.
No.
In fact, they'll be probably in the bottom four, but if they can win a few more games, I think there's some excitement there.
Love
well,
it.
There you go.
Always enjoy this day, Rennie.
Check this late September.
Yeah, exactly.
No, we don't do that. We destroy it. We burn it. Never to be heard from
this
again.
Never existed.
Exactly right. Get rid of the tapes. Thank you, Rennie.
Good on you. Thanks, Will. Thanks, David.
Gliderol Garage Doors, adding strength, style and safety to your home. Gliderol.com.au.
This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Partly cloudy and 33 today with the 6:30 news. I'm Graham Bullings.
Chipped windscreen? Complete Windscreens can repair it from just $99. Look for the big red koala.
South Australia is set for an economic boom, with China about to remove its crippling tariffs on wine. A final decision is expected in late March, after Australia reached an agreement with China late last year to work towards ditching the duties placed on Aussie wine in 2021. Wine critic Ray Jordan says the industry has been struggling since then.
There's an awful lot of wine sitting in tanks, especially in South Australia, which is the country's biggest wine-producing state. And a lot of it is, well, it's sitting there in tank. It's all gas stuff. It's not going to go off. But, boy, there's a lot of wine to start moving very quickly.
Premier Peter Malinauskas has welcomed the news.
When the tariffs were imposed, South Australian wine exports to China went from being worth just shy of $1 billion down to $3 million. That's a big hit. And that's money coming out of the pockets of hardworking people and businesses in our state. So by choosing to engage in a principled way, we've been able to get a good result here, and hopefully it becomes a final decision before the end of this month.
It's unclear what started a house fire in the northern suburbs last night. The alarm was raised at Albert Street in Kilburn just before 8:30. Crystal Mitchell from the MFS says it took 20 minutes to extinguish the blaze.
The ceiling has fallen in and the house has suffered significant amount of damage.
Damage is estimated at $300,000 and the fire is considered suspicious. There'll be a court appearance today for cyclist Rowan Dennis. The 33-year-old has been charged with causing death by dangerous driving, as well as one count of driving without due care. It's alleged he was behind the wheel when his 32-year-old wife, Melissa, was struck down outside their Madindi home on December 30 last year. He's been on police bail caring for their two young children. The White House says $300 million US in emergency supplies of weapons and equipment will go to Ukraine. US correspondent Jonathan Kersley reports.
With $60 billion US dollars of American aid for Ukraine tied up in Congress, the White House announced emergency support measures, saying weapons and equipment will be sent to Ukraine. National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan declared it would not be anywhere near enough to help Ukraine defeat Russia. Poland's President and Prime Minister are also due to meet President Joe Biden at the White House today to discuss more support for Ukraine.
The Commonwealth Bank has experienced a nationwide outage, although services are returning to normal. CommBank warns that some online payments may still be delayed. A report is being prepared for the coroner after a death at a southern suburbs beach. Mel Usher has the details.
An elderly man has died in a suspected drowning at Aldinga Beach. A group pulled him from the water around 3 yesterday afternoon, but he couldn't be saved. The scene playing out in front of the 79-year-old's wife. They had just celebrated 60 years of marriage. Police say there are no suspicious circumstances.
And now turning to 5AA Sport.
Colours, custom design, any house, any style. Gliderol Garage Doors, gliderol.com.au.
And now here's Tom Wren.
Thank you for that, Graham. Let's start with footy first, and the Crows will hold their main training session at West Lakes this morning as they look ahead to Saturday night's season opener against Gold Coast. Much of the attention will centre on forward Taylor Walker, who's battling a sore back. Well, meantime, AFL great Lee Matthews has delivered a scathing assessment of Richmond's opening round performance, calling it horrible. The Tigers marked Adam Uzay's first game as coach with a 39-point thumping by the Suns on the Gold Coast. Matthews telling Wide World of Sports, the Tigers have dropped off significantly since their premiership era.
Suns were fantastic. So they were dominating the scoreboard, and Richmond, they just look horrible, really. Like, no energy, they just couldn't get anything going. Even of the team that played for Richmond last Saturday, there would have been 12 to 15 that were part of their premiership teams, I think, probably that many.
A Melbourne City midfielder has scored one of the most incredible goals in A-League history overnight. Terry Antonis lobbed the keeper from just over the halfway line as City thumped the Western Sydney Wanderers 7-0.
It's going to be a record defeat for Western Sydney Wanderers. And here's a cheeky one. Oh, my words! That just sums it up. Terry Antonis scoring from his own half of the field. What an extraordinary exclamation mark.
Yeah, amazing goal. Commentary on Paramount Plus. Meantime, the European Champions League round of 16 continues this morning. Matches have just kicked off with Arsenal trailing Porto 1-0 heading into their second leg. Barcelona takes on Napoli in the other tie. And that's the 5AA Sport.
And now the 5AA Forecast.
No better time or place to jump in a Jayco than at Jayco Adelaide's brand new West Beach dealership.
33 and partly cloudy today, tomorrow a late shower or 2:28, 28 on Friday with a possible shower, and Saturday mostly sunny 31. Right now in Adelaide it's 23. More news as it happens on 5AA.
Always local. 5AA. Always Adelaide.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on. Touch base. Search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
25 minutes to 7. Police and weather coming up this half hour. A whole stack of texts have come in, though, over the course of the first 30 minutes. As we navigated news headlines and everyone's incredibly well-researched top 8 predictions for 2024. We'll check the Dutton's text line now. Big Ten Ford, Judo Mahabal, Hyundai, Isuzu, Ute, Mazda, Mitsubishi, Nissan, Ram, Subaru and Volkswagen. Dutton's, easy to do business with.
One here from Joe, clearly a Port supporter. Come on, boys, please don't rubbish West Coast. I don't want you jinxing the game for this week. Ali says, guys, just a reminder, China's interim decision to lift import duties is only interim. It's not a done deal yet. So we probably need to keep a lid on it until the final decision is handed down. That's probably true, although all the sounds coming out of Canberra, like particularly behind the scenes, this is...
Interim seems more a product of the process rather than a suggestion that they are umming and ahhing about the final decision.
Because is it under the World Trade Organization's rules?
That was the dispute was being mediated.
And there's some line in the stories I read about how Australia now has a chance to write some sort of submission itself, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, it was elevated to an official dispute level, but on country to country level, the trade off was stop going on about your whole origins of COVID investigation. We might talk candidly about what tariff we remove.
The weird thing is, none of that had anything to do with trade at all.
No.
What was their actual justification for it? Because they always said it had nothing to do with COVID. It was bizarre. It was something about, like, the volume of grapes or something.
No, they were saying it was dumping, weren't they? They were dumping cheap rubbish there and undermining the markets.
The Chinese wine industry.
Yeah. When it wasn't. Their point was, you weren't behaving how friends behave if we're meant to be mates.
Hey, did anybody get Matilda's tickets yesterday?
Love to hear from someone who did.
I tried and failed.
Mm.
Kate tried and failed. And that was within 11 minutes of them going on sale. And I couldn't even get in. It was the same as what happened with Taylor Swift. Like, there was that waiting room thing, and Ticketek was saying, refresh every 8 seconds, refresh every 8 seconds. And Kate got through, and she tried to get four. General admission, and it said, nope, there's no groups of four in GA. And then she tried to get four any category, apart from, like, the crazy ones. And then it said, there's only one seat. You can get lots of one seat. And then she thought, well, maybe I'll see if I can buy individual seats. And then it said, allocation exhausted.
Yeah, they went in an hour. So there was 30,000 pre-sale that went in 4 hours last week, and then the remainder that went up went off in an hour yesterday. There's going to be another release closer to the day, but we'll talk more about that after 7 o'clock today. But if you're someone who did manage to get tickets, what was your secret? 8223-0000, text us on the Dutton's text line. Is anyone excited about the prospect of an EV ute? Because the federal government, Anthony Albanese, is going to have to be, if they're going to hit their targets when it comes to how efficient the Australian car fleet is by 2029. According to new research by the Australian Automobile Association, at least half of new utes sold in Australia would have to be electric by 2029 for Labor to reach the emissions reduction goal that they have set.
So within 5 years.
Within 5 years. So this comes, of course, as part of the policy that we've discussed about fuel efficiency standards, in which emissions from large family cars and utes would have to be cut by 60% over that period of 5 years. The Automobile Association's own research from the Centre of International Economics found that demand for electronic vehicles would have to grow in the next 4 years by staggering amounts. 40% of new SUV and family car sales would have to be electric, and 50% of utes by 2029. But here's the thing I found most interesting in this report that I think has been totally underplayed in the discussion of this entire thing by everyone in a policy sense, but no one on the text line. The group said to reach this level of intake, the price of electric vehicles would have to come down to between $30,000 and $142,000 below internal combustion engines to get to this level. But the research revealed consumer preference found many Australian drivers valued factors such as towing capacity and range more than cost. Now, Labor's entire policy is built around the idea that this will bring cost down. Well, the independent research says there's other factors far beyond cost that influence Australians' car buying preferences. Mm. And the technology isn't there yet. Maybe it will be in 5 years, but will we have made a 50% change to the SUV sales in Australia in that time? Will we have made a 60% change to ute sales in that time?
Well, you think too about how long it takes for a new model to first come online and then for it to become available in Australia. Now, when I had a Hilux, I had an SR5, which wasn't like the... It was like I always think of it in the context of the L, SL and SLE Commodore, so which was the first release of the Commodore. So the SR5 was like the SLE. It was like the best one, but the cheapest version of the best one, if that makes sense.
Yep.
So it wasn't like the rugged one with all the bells and whistles. It didn't have the snorkel on it or anything like that. But it was you know, a really good car. Now, I still think of that as like the new version.
Mm.
But the reality is it's, and Toyota dealers / owners who are more into cars than me, correct me if I'm wrong, but that's almost like 10 years ago that happened. And it still feels like the new model, or maybe it's the second oldest version, I don't know. But the point I'm making is that when it came out, that had been years in the making for Toyota. And it was the one where suddenly everyone in Australia went, oh, yeah, these cars are great. I really want to get one of these Hiluxes. So if that model, that still relatively new model, is actually in reality that old, how on earth are we going to do all this in 5 years?
You know, the thing that's interesting to think about.
And you couldn't get any delivered for a long time either.
No, that's right.
There's still waiting lists for these cars.
How many people are listening right now? And give us a call. Tell us what you're thinking of. We'll have to buy a car in the next 5 years. We'll get a new car in the next 5 years. It's probably a reasonable proportion. 50 to 60% of those people, whatever the vehicle is going to be, will have to buy an EV to meet our emissions targets in the next 5 years. That seems unimaginable that we'll achieve that.
I reckon the really scary thing, though, is like you get the sense with Chris Bowen that he's never actually spent a single day of his life in what the rest of us like to call the real world. He wasn't the mayor of Penrith when he was like 17. He's like the sort of Doogie Howser of the Labor Party. Never dug a hole. I don't think he's ever worked as a, you know, he's just got this soft hands, closeted politician look about him. And you hear it when it comes to his lack of empathy on power prices, his ideologically driven giddiness with excitement about renewables.
Yep.
Even though we all know how much power currently costs because we're not at the point where we can do it all through renewables. You hear it in his juvenile pig-headedness about the nuclear debate, and you really hear it with this. You just get the sense that this is a guy who, from cradle to grave, has been driving around in a government car.
Mm. 8223 0000 is the number. Already getting a huge response on the Dutton's text line. But how many of our listeners are planning on the next car to be an electric vehicle? Let's just put it there. And if you're someone who drives a ute for work,
no.
Would
you buy one at the moment?
Oh, if it was cost effective, but it's not.
No.
Well, not for an SUV.
The other thing too is like the distances that we have to drive for the fun part of our driving lives, school holidays, you know, let's go to Mount Gambier, go to the barn for dinner, go to the Coonawarra, go and see the Blue Lake, maybe go down, you know, check out the Glenelg River, do a bit of bushwalking. Like,
see, I don't see the electric car discussion as an ideological one like a lot of people do. Like, you know, I'm being pushed to do this and so you're resistant, or people saying we should be doing this to save the planet. I frankly don't care. Does it work out in a positive cash sense for me? Is it cheaper? Can it do everything I want it to do when it's cheaper? Well, then I'd buy one. That's all I care about.
Well, there was a great poll a few years ago that I reckon still tells the story of the public's assessment of climate change in terms of its reality and the type of behavioural change it should necessitate. An overwhelming majority of Australians believe that climate change is real, and when asked, are you prepared to pay more to help, the answer to that is no.
That's
a fair answer when you've got a whole bunch of other stuff going on in your life.
And you've, especially
like paying off your damn house.
Well, look.
Or your power bills.
If the leader of the Greens can't say no to private jet travel, I'm going to find it hard to say yes to electronic vehicles in the meantime.
That's amazing, that story. Adam Bant, what did he pay, $14,000 for a private jet?
Private jet. This is the climate emergency guy.
You know, Bronnie Bishop lost her job for a $5,000 helicopter ride.
Yeah. How things have changed. Let's have a look at these texts because they're going nuts on the EV question.
Oh, I haven't even looked at them yet with all the chit-chat. The electric utes would be real handy on a farm. Not. Another one here. from Mark. I work for a large company and the fleet manager trialled EV SUVs. We drive 700 kilometres a week. They're just not practical. The range is terrible. Robert says, with the EV utes, I think the Yank car companies have abandoned the attempt and work out it's cheaper to cop the government fines for not achieving the targets. Brenton says, guys, I have no interest in EVs, and if they can bring one out that can tow my 1.6-ton boat 600 kilometres without stopping, just like my V8 Commodore, which was the exact point you were making before, Will. Tony says, is my work going to pay my electricity bill to charge my work ute at home every night? Am I going to be paid while I wait at a charger during work hours? Yesterday I drove to the border and back. Another one here from Ben. We don't have the infrastructure across the outer suburban and country areas to support the widespread rollout of electric vehicles.
Yeah, I think there's an inevitability about this in terms of cost, infrastructure, and the technology will improve over time. But the idea that 50 to 60% of sales are going to be EVs in 5 years to me seems like the stuff of fantasy.
Completely.
Ray and McGill's called in. Morning to you, Ray.
Oh, good morning, guys. Look, I'll be buying a car probably next year, but I just wanted to talk about the minister more in general. I mean, this guy's been through more portfolios than, I don't know, Warren Buffett. And every single one he's been through, he's stuffed up. I remember when he was the Minister for Financial Services, and there was a big inquiry. They changed all the laws about finance, financial planning, and so forth. And he made all these recommendations. And then at the summit, someone said, "Oh, how does your financial planner charge?" And he said, "Oh, I've never been to see one." And the same happened with accounting. So I think he just lives in nowhere, really, trying to lift lives of people in areas and sectors he's got nothing to do with.
Yeah, completely. Completely.
Thank you, Ray. We've got a whole stack of calls that we'll get on in just a moment on 8223 0000. It's a big talking point. Big shift in the way the federal government sees your life changing. And that is always interesting to talk about. That's coming up in a moment. Let's check traffic first. Police and weather shortly. When the UV's 3 and above, cover up your sun protection. Stay SunSmart. Download the SunSmart app.
Thanks, Will, and good morning, David. A Cowandilla car and motorcycle crash today. St. Donald Bramber Drive near Bagot Avenue. Works at Queenstown, a bit slow at the moment. Old Port Road near Victoria Street. Speed's reduced there and is getting busy at the moment at St. Mary's. South Road near Princess Parade. She's down at 40 for road plates there. You find cameras Frederick Road, Grange, and Jeffcott Street at North Adelaide. The King Living Anniversary Sale in Sunday. Save up to 50% on selected Australian Design Award-winning furniture. Sale in Sunday. Visit the King Living Keswick showroom today. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Emergencies don't recognise business hours. They can happen at any time and need professional attention in no time. With Adelaide's only 24-hour private emergency department, Calvary Adelaide provides expert treatment at any hour on any day. You'll experience shorter wait times before receiving personalised care from experienced professionals. For emergency care 24/7, trust South Australia's newest state-of-the-art hospital, Calvary Adelaide. 120 Angus Street, Adelaide.
Make your move into a new Mazda at the Mawson Lakes Mazda M event. From March 12 to 16, enjoy an M event bonus of up to $2,000 off a wide range of 2023 plated Mazda models, including the CX-3, CX-30, CX-5 and BT-50. Head to Mawson Lakes Mazda for the M event and make it yours while stocks last. Salisbury Highway, just a short drive from the city. Terms, conditions and exclusions apply. See mazda.com.au for details.
Toolkit Depot's exclusive three-day Makita sale event starts this Thursday. Whether you're shopping in-store or online, don't miss out on incredible Makita deals.
Sign up for free as a TKD Club or trade member and get double discounts on the entire Makita range, from power tools and outdoor gear to accessories, 12-volt, 18-volt, 40-volt, anything. Makita means double the savings for TKD members.
Plus, mega Makita battery deals and exclusive offers across the whole 3 days.
Toolkit Depot's three-day Makita sale event this Thursday to Saturday, in-store or online at toolkitdepot.com.au. Toolkit Depot, everything you need to get the job done.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube. Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on. Touch base. Search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
9 to 7. A little bit cooler this morning. Jenny Horvat at the Weather Bureau joins us. Jenny, just take us through what Wednesday has in store.
Yeah, so we've had that bit of a trough move through, so just taking the edge off those temperatures, and those winds have come around to the south-southeast. Minimum temperature we saw about 20 past 6, 23.2, currently 23.8 degrees at the West Terrace Night Appear observation site. Quite a bit of cloud extending across from the west, but we are expecting it to remain dry today. Top temperature in Adelaide around 32, 33 degrees, maybe getting up to around 34 across the northern suburbs and around 31, 32 along the coast. Mount Barker looking at around 29 degrees for today. With that cloud still hanging around, looking to see maybe a little bit of shower activity coming through on the Thursday, probably more likely in later in the day, but we'll see how we go. We're not expecting too much and potentially maybe a little bit of shower activity around on the Friday morning there as well. Temperatures back down to around 28 degrees for both Thursday and Friday, and those minimums coming down as well, so cooler nights coming up. Thursday minimum around 19, Friday's down to around 15. On the weekend there, we are looking at things drying up mostly. Temperatures of around 31 for Saturday, getting up to around 33 for Sunday, guys.
Bit more heat on the way, and the rain record may not be broken.
Yeah, that's right. Sounds like it. Some rain in play. Thank you, Jenny. Let's head to safe. I'll send you Constable Kimberly Broad on the line. Kimberly, it's been a suspicious house fire at Torrensville.
Yeah, good morning. It was just after 10 o'clock last night. Emergency services were called to West Street, Torrensville, after reports of a house fire. Now, when crews arrived, they saw a large amount of smoke issuing from one side of a single-storey duplex. Now, those occupants managed to escape without injury, and MFS brought the blaze under control in about 30 minutes. Damage was caused to the adjoining premises, but thankfully there were no reports of injuries. So we had fire corps investigators attend the scene to gather some evidence, and patrols door knocked the area. But we do believe that the fire may have been deliberately lit. So we're just asking anyone with information to contact Crime Stoppers on 1-800-333-000.
Kimberly, also, what about this drunk driver who crashed at Torrens Park?
Yeah, so this is about 11:45 last night. We were called to Belair Road, Torrens Park, after reports that Mazda sedan had crashed into a road sign. Now, extensive damage was caused to the vehicle, but luckily there were no reports of injuries. So that driver was submitted to a breath test, and she's allegedly produced a blood alcohol reading of 0.175. So a 32-year-old woman from Morfettvale, she's been reported for drink driving and issued with a 12-month instant loss of licence. So she'll be appearing in court Adelaide at 8 for those charges.
Good on you, Kimberly. Thank you for that. Senior Constable Kimberly Broad from SAPOL. Would you fancy living on Graham Corn's Court? It's just across from Neil Curley Court and intersects Carl Viet Avenue. These are all streets at Legends Estate Park in Whyalla. We happened across this because we keep an eye on the emergency warnings that are going on, and there was a curious alarm that went off at Graham Corn's Court. We thought, well, what's going on there? And so Lucy investigated, and we learnt more about Legends Estate Park in Whyalla. The mayor of the Whyalla City Council, Phil Stone, joins us. Phil, looking at the pictures online, how long has this housing development been up and running, and is it finished yet, or is it sort of still in the construction phase?
Good morning, guys. Well, it came to being 20-odd years ago in 2004. A housing developer wanted a point of difference when he was coming up with this estate, decided to call it Legends Estate and named the streets after sporting legends who were either born in Whyalla or who lived there for some parts of their life and had a great impact on our community and the rest of the South Australian community afterwards. So there's about 9 streets there. It's almost 9 hectares in size. There's around about 100 homes. There are still some blocks there if somebody wanted to move to Whyalla and be part of the Legends Estate. But yes, how could you have a Legends Estate with names like Cornsey, Graham Corns, Neil Curley, Barry Robram? Barry Robram, for people that don't know, was actually born in Whyalla. And look at Carl Viet. You know, started playing soccer around 4 years of age in Whyalla. Look at him now, head coach of Adelaide United. And other streets named after sporting identities that may not be so well known, but certainly something different in Whyalla.
Now, I had no idea, Phil. That's great. But to have it down to that such a specific local level,
they're
huge names with a link to Whyalla. Huge
well, that's it. If you look at some of the others, Vern Schupan. Now, he was born in Boolaroo Centre in Mid-North, grew up in Whyalla, started his, he's a retired Australian motorsport driver now, started racing go-karts, got to the highest level, moved on. Julie Franco Place, regarded as one of Australia's finest centre-court netball players for the Australian Diamonds. And the list goes on, with people may not be so well-known outside Waller, but had a great impact. So it was certainly something very different at the time, and still talked about within Waller.
That's an excellent story. Good on you, Phil. Phil Stone there, the mayor of the Waller City Council, about Legends Estate Park in Waller.
Nice Murray. Way of celebrating your local legends, isn't it?
Carl Viet had a very big day. Was it yesterday? His daughter got married to that's Riley
right.
Knight.
Yeah, that's right.
So he walked her down the aisle.
Good on you, Carl. I really like Carl Viet. Like, they're having a rough trot at the moment, Adelaide United, but he's a legend of the game.
Oh, for sure.
Nationally, as well as here in South Australia.
Yeah.
And indeed, obviously, in Waller as well.
Yeah. What about that? I like that idea. Because so many street names, you think, oh, yeah, it doesn't really mean anything to anyone, does it? You know what? We should do a better job of is there an Ann Wills Street?
Well, especially when so many housing developments are coming on. You know, we've got 10,000 homes being built here or there or elsewhere. There's an opportunity for contemporary recognition of people that have mattered to areas. I like the idea of, you know, you could name them after people if it was a housing development in the northern suburb, people that are from that part of Adelaide, for example.
Well, there's the Max Fatchin
Highway
through his long dedication to Salisbury, the great poet. We're getting so many calls about electric vehicles.
Yeah, we're going to have to get to those in a moment. We will do that. Keep them coming in. 8223 00 00. 5AA News is coming up.
Get great value hands down this Easter at Coles with 40% off Cadbury Dairy Milk Easter Hunt Box, 306 grams, just $8. That's great value hands down at Coles. Offer ends Tuesday while stocks last. No rain checks.
Hello, Frank Walker from National Tiles. It's raining free tiles at National Tiles. Yes, National Tiles are giving away free tiles for the month of March. At National Tiles, buy 3 square metres of almost all of our tiles, laminate or timber flooring, and we'll give you 1 square metre absolutely free. No catches, no gimmicks, but you'll have to be quick. So rush into National Tiles for your free tiles, laminate or timber flooring now before it's too late. Conditions apply.
This is life-changing. The Hospital Research Foundation Home Lottery's $3.6 million grand prize is spectacular seaside living at Henley Beach. You could be living on permanent holiday mortgage-free in a fully furnished Scott Salisbury home with $250,000 cash in the bank. Get your tickets now. Join the fight and support life-changing medical research for all South Australians. Homelottery.com.au. Licence M14493.
Hi, I'm Jo. I'm a registered nurse and I work with St. Louis Home Care as a clinical care coordinator.
St. Louis was started by my great-grandmother and is one big, happy family with lovely staff just like Jo.
The people that work for St. Louis are very loving and caring.
Whether it's personal care, preparing meals, shopping, home maintenance or social activities, we help people stay at home for longer.
If you're interested, come and join us.
Google St. Louis Home Care today.
It's Edward from Edwardstown Mazda. The M-Invent is on now. It's really big. So here's a big person to tell you more.
Thanks, Edward. He's right. Our once-a-year M-Event is on now and it's big.
How big?
Think huge M-Event factory bonuses plus a $2,000 trade-in bonus exclusive to Edwardstown Mazda.
Wow.
I know. The M-Event on now.
Now play that jingle sing, please.
It's gotta be
Edwardstown Mazda.
Local news and information first. This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Partly cloudy and 33 today with the 7 o'clock news. Good morning, I'm Graham Goodings.
From chips to replacements, make Complete Windscreens your insurer repairer of choice. CompleteWindscreens.com.au.
South Australia is set to be the big beneficiary when China is expected to drop its crippling wine tariffs later this month. There are huge quantities of wine sitting in storage, particularly in SA, which is the nation's biggest wine producer. China was Australia's biggest wine market, worth more than $1 billion in 2019. Premier Peter Malinauskas has welcomed the impending removal of the tariffs.
We're now hopefully only days away from this interim decision being a final one, meaning that all those tariffs are lifted on South Australian wine, and that's worth around about $1 billion to the South Australian wine industry. Growers, suppliers, wineries themselves. It's a big deal for them, and it's important for our state.
Cyclist Rowan Dennis will face court today for the first time, charged over his wife's death. Mel Usher reports.
33-year-old Rowan Dennis has been on police bail since the death of his wife, Melissa Hoskins. She was struck by a vehicle, allegedly driven by Mr. Dennis, outside their Medindie home on December 30. 32-year-old Melissa was taken to hospital but succumbed to her injuries. Melissa was a world champion cyclist and two-time Olympian who retired from the sport in 2017. She married Dennis the next year, with whom she had two children. Mr. Dennis was arrested and charged with causing death by dangerous driving, as well as one count of driving without due care. Police will allege he drove recklessly or at speed or in a manner which was dangerous to any person, and by that culpable negligence, recklessness or other conduct caused the death of Melissa Marie Dennis.
It's unclear what started a house fire in these northern suburbs last night. The alarm was raised at Albert Street in Kilburn just before 8:30. Crystal Mitchell from the MFS says it took 20 minutes to extinguish the blaze.
The ceiling has fallen in and the house has suffered significant amount of damage.
Damage is estimated at $300,000 and the fire is being treated as suspicious. New data has found retired couples will need $72,000 a year to live comfortably. The Association of Superannuation Funds says high insurance, electricity and food costs have pushed the figure up significantly on last year. Doctors are asking the federal government to remove barriers preventing vulnerable patients in the bush from accessing vital health services. Almost a third of the population is based in rural and remote Australia. Royal Australian College of Physicians President Dr. Jacqueline Small says distance is an issue many residents are faced with, which could be addressed by improving telehealth services.
The inability to access virtual health care, whether that's by telephone or video, can have a major impact on the ability to access medical specialist care. It can take a very long time to travel to a major city. We see there are other and better ways for patients to access care.
The life-size hyperreal sperm whale first appeared on Saturday morning at Glenelg Beach, drawing crowds of 100,000 people over 3 days, is now on the move. The theatre piece, created by Belgian-based group the Captain Boomer Collective and part of the Adelaide Festival, delivered a powerful statement about the environment and climate change. The whale is being moved today to Elder Park, next to the Torrens River and in front of the Adelaide Festival Centre. Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Gliderol Garage Doors, adding strength, style and safety to your home. Gliderol.com.au.
And good morning, Tom Wren.
And a very good morning to you as well, Graeme. We'll start with some football. It's a big morning for both the South Australian football clubs, the Crows and Port Adelaide, to hit the training track ahead of their round one matches this weekend. The Power, of course, playing on Sunday against West Coast, while the Crows will tackle Gold Coast on Saturday night. And there's a bit of a great unknown heading into round one, how the teams who played in opening round perform against the sides with the weekend off. Melbourne will face the Dogs, Gold Coast the Crows, the Giants North Melbourne, and Fremantle will host Brisbane. To cricket, Aussie coach Andrew McDonald has leapt to the defence of struggling Steve Smith. Australia's premier batsman has scored just 51 runs from four innings in his new role as an opener. That was in the recent series against New Zealand. McDonald rubbishing calls to move Smith back to the middle order.
I don't think it's deserved. I think he'll be able to work through that. It's a new challenge for him. It's a new position. And if you're bringing in a new opener and you gave them four test matches and then said, oh, okay, we're going to shift that after four test matches, would you think that's fair or unfair? Oh, I think it's reasonably unfair.
Elise Perry, meantime, has become the first player to take a six-wicket haul in the WIPL, and the Redbacks are on top of their Shield clash against Tasmania and Hobart, the Tigers to resume at 1-for-8. That's in their second inning, still needing 316 runs to win. Well, Melbourne City has equaled the biggest winning margin in A-League history, beating Western Sydney 7-0. And Aussie Tyler Wright has won through to the semi-finals of the World Surf League event in Portugal. And that's the 5AA Sport.
And now checking 5AA traffic.
You park your car in the shade, same goes for you. Park yourself in the shade. Be sun smart.
Good morning there at Cowandilla. Karen motorcycle crash at Donald Rabbit Drive near Bagot Avenue. Slow for works this morning at Coromandel Valley, Main Road near Black Road, speeds at 40, and a bit sluggish right now at Brooklyn Parks, Donald Rabbit Drive near Marion Road, speeds at 40 there. Getting busy, South Road at Edwardstown with cameras, Days Road, Croydon Park, and Tapley's Hill Road at Fulham. This March, Bob Jane T-Marts have a great buy three, get one free, plus instant cashback deals. With 15 stores located in Adelaide, they'll look after you, T's and C's apply. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
And now the 5AA forecast.
No better time or place to jump in a Jayco than at Jayco Adelaide's brand new West Beach dealership.
Partly cloudy and 33 today. Some rain on the way. Tomorrow a late shower on 28 degrees. Friday a possible shower, 28. Saturday mostly sunny, 31. Right now it's 24 in Adelaide. More news as it happens on 5AA.
Streaming live via the 5AA player app. On DAB Digital Radio. And on 1395 AM. This is 5AA. Always Adelaide.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on. Touch base. Search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
Not exactly blinding lights out there at the moment this morning, looking at the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream. Overcast sort of a day. It's going to be the next couple of days before the sun comes out, the warms back up again for the weekend, albeit thankfully not to the levels we saw this past weekend. So houses around the city should slowly be coming down in temperature over the course of the next couple of days. Really fascinating debate in the first hour of the program this morning that was started by a submission from the Australian Automobile Association to the federal government's proposed new vehicles efficiency standard scheme that's basically made this point. Simply having price parity between electric vehicles and old-fashioned combustion engine vehicles won't mean people necessarily choose EVs. The technology needs to keep up with the demand, and that's coming through on the text line. In fact, there's a good disparity of debate at the moment from people who use their vehicles for work and have to travel large distances, or people who, for recreation, tow boats and things, and others who are saying, well, I don't understand how any of this doesn't make sense. I just drive around the suburbs and EVs make perfect sense for me. So let's take some calls on this and get a sense what the 5AA Breakfast audience makes of it all. Gary in Collinswood kicks us off. Morning, Gary.
Good morning, guys. Yeah, just quickly, look, I wouldn't be buying an electric vehicle, not at this stage, maybe down the track, but there's a lot of things they've got to sort out. Just quickly, over in California, Hertz, half of their electric vehicles they got rid of because they had too much trouble trying to get them repaired and all the other things with it.
Hmm.
The other thing was a couple had hired a electric car driving around, and they said, oh, we better charge it up. Went to a charging station. There was about 10 charge stations, but there's about 50 vehicles there. And all these stations took an hour to fill. So they got an app, they went to another one, same thing, went to another one, same thing. But so by this time, the vehicle's getting low on electricity. So they thought just before the night, they'll try another one. And there was no one there. There was three charging stations and no one was around. And they thought, oh, happy days. They got there. They're all damaged. So that's why there was nobody there. So they took their car back. They just went back to the hotel because they only had about 10% in their car. They took it back the next day. And, of course, because they've only got 10%, as you know, with cars, you've got to have them filled up with petrol or whatever, they got a huge fine because the car had only had 10% in it. They didn't bring it back as 100%.
Yeah, right. So, like not enough fuel in the tank. And they charge you $2.50 per litre. Yeah.
So, yeah, there's a few things. Oh, that was the other thing too, sorry. The day before, they thought, oh, they'll go at midnight. Same thing, there's still about 50 cars lined up to get the electricity, so...
Yeah, there's an infrastructure problem, there's no doubt about that. Thank you, Gary. Jim, good morning.
Good morning, guys. How you doing?
Good, thanks, Jim.
Hey, I'd just like to correct the former caller. Perth's actually only got rid of about 20% of their EV vehicles, not half. And they bought them during the COVID peak in car prices, which meant their business model of buying and reselling vehicles, and those vehicles were going to hit a large amount of depreciation. They were also being used as Uber vehicles, which meant they're seeing a lot more Ks than the rest of their fleet. So just a bit of context around that situation. I have an EV. I also have a couple of other vehicles. The EV we have is a Tesla Model 3 Performance. We got rid of a former car to get that. To be honest, mate, I don't think I'll ever buy another petrol engine new vehicle ever again. In regards to work, I actually drive trucks for a living, and I work for council, and we probably don't do more than 100 to 200 Ks a day, which is easy doable in the EV trucks coming out. But what you'll see is as time progresses, we're going to get purpose-built EV platformed vehicles, which are much more efficient than what's on offer today.
Mm.
And the 2027 targets are in price parity. So yes, at 2027, we'll have price parity for purchase price of vehicles, but the total cost of ownership is what people should be looking at, because it'll be a lot lower. It's already a lot lower for my Tesla. Yeah. So when you start looking at, you're paying, say, like $1.80 per litre for petrol, compared to, you know, $12 for an entire battery to charge up, and that's not including the free charges around, or using your solar at home, or taking advantage of off-peak time of use tariff, stuff like that. It is really, really affordable. And to be honest, I rarely drive more than 500 k's a day, so it's always full. I wake up every morning full tank, or full battery, I should say. It's much more convenient.
But, Jim, aren't you talking about things that have an upfront cost there, i.e. the Tesla and the home battery, that for the average punter are still prohibitively expensive in an upfront sense?
Well, you can get a... Well, let's have a look at the cheaper options. BYD Atto 3. A BYD Atto 3, I think they're around 55 at the moment, not including the $3,000 rebate you could possibly get at the moment. I'm sure that's expired. But that, the acceleration of that will keep up with a Mustang, and it's a little SUV. But the instant torque, I take people for a test, like a drive in our Tesla Performance, and it blows people away. They are unaware of how good these vehicles are.
Yeah, the Teslas are beautiful cars.
Yeah, that's an interesting call from someone who sounds like a convert to the cause.
Absolutely. Good on you, Jim. Thank you, Jim. We'll take one more. Let's go to Croydon Park. Vic, good morning.
Good morning, boys. Yeah, I bought myself an RV from Jayco 3 weeks ago. It's a diesel 2.3 turbo. There's no way in the world I buy myself an EV. And a lot of other people are doing the same thing. Look, there's a year waiting list just on RVs that have these diesel motors. And then if I see EVs like this, you know, you have between an adult and an embryo. Well, the EVs are still in the embryonic form. They're still in mama's garage. You know what I mean?
Yeah, they'll grow up at some point, but we're not yet there, Vic.
So, you know, I've got an RV coming up in a year, and it's a huge company, Jayco. They advertise with 5AA. And there's no way on earth I'm going to buy myself an EV yet, because I know a lot about them, and they don't cut the mustard.
All right, thank you, Vic.
One question I've got is, how long does the battery last? Because, you know, people talk about, like, Toyota engines last forever. You know, your whole car can, like, you know, get burnt to a crisp and the engine's still going 30 years later. They're amazingly well made. But isn't the shelf life of a battery still about 10 years?
Yeah, I'm not sure about that. I don't know. Maybe one of our listeners can tell us. There must be cars in the fleet that are a decade old now.
I tell you what, though, people have made the change, though. Like Bill in Bradbury, he says you'd be stupid not to go electric. My wife bought a BYD 2 months ago, and with our home solar system, she's actually saving $80 a week thanks to NRG Solar.
Yeah, I think if you've got solar, it would make a hell of a lot of
sense.
What do
you do, plug your car into your Tesla battery?
We just plug it into your PowerPoint, and it would draw from the battery.
Of course, yeah.
14 minutes after 7, great calls, keep them coming in, 8223 000, you can text us on the Dutton's text line as well. Big 10 Ford, Jidham, Havel, Hyundai, Isuzu, Ute, Mazda, Mitsubishi, Nissan, Ram, Subaru and Volkswagen. Dutton's, easy to do business with. Let's jump into some of the other news headlines this morning. The biggest and most exciting for South Australia, of course, being the interim determination by the Chinese government to lift tariffs on Australian wine. It's an export market that was valued at $946 million in October 2020 for South Australia. With the tariffs slapped on, it went down to $2.7 million. You can see easily the size scale of this decision, what it'll mean for jobs, what it'll mean for the local economy. Angus Taylor was talking about it on Sky News this morning.
It's been a real malaise for the wine industry across Australia. It's broader than just the Chinese market, but it's a very significant downturn that they've seen. And so any good news in getting access to markets is something that I think will be very strongly welcomed. We always have to do these things in a way that doesn't compromise our values. I think that's first and foremost the principle that the government should be deploying, but at the same time, I think it is consistent with our values that we pursue trade opportunities wherever we can. So let's wait and see how this plays out, but I'm certainly, it will certainly be welcomed by the industry if this is achieved. Yep.
That's good news. The other good news story is that the Matildas juggernaut rolls on. Another sellout, and of course, Adelaide people, we go to stuff. It was never in doubt. The 13th straight home game that the Matildas have sold out, albeit this time it took less time than ever for it to sell out. 30,000 pre-sale tickets went in 4 hours last week. The remainder went on sale at noon yesterday, and by 1 o'clock, they were all gone. I got a text from a mate of mine, Doug, who managed to get 5 tickets.
Oh,
and I said,
Doug.
You got the magic touch, Doug.
Did you get any?
I didn't get any, no.
No.
No. No. I didn't try. I'm never organised enough to get on these sort of, you have to be online at this time sales.
Yeah.
If that's what it requires, I'm not going.
Mm.
I miss everything I want to go
to. Do you think
to.
Maybe they need a special comments boundary writer type person?
I would have thought. I don't know who's...
Who's got the rights?
I don't know who's doing it. I'd like to get along. I'd prefer not to be working, but, you know, I'll do whatever it takes.
Lucy just piped up in my ear saying she wants that gig too.
It's a two-game series against China, which is effectively the farewell for the Olympics, which, unlike the men's, obviously, for the women's, is a full-strength Matilda's outfit that'll be going along. It's a huge tournament and massively important. The Adelaide Oval match, May 31, Sydney on June 3. As much as the girls and the team is the story, so too are the fans. I loved this grab from someone getting along who was lining up yesterday that we played on 7 News last night.
Oh my God, oh my God, we're seeing the Matildas, holy crap.
I would never line up for a Broadway show. I would never line up to see the King. I would never line up to see the Prime Minister. But I am lining up for the Matildas.
I just want to get a ticket to see my favourite team, the Matildas.
What about that interview we did with Moya Dodd a couple of months ago? I think it was when she got the AO, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm, yep.
When she played in the World Cup in Brisbane, there were about 70 people at the game.
Yeah.
Like, they were all the sort of admin people and family and friends, but the actual crowd was about 70.
That's amazing, isn't it?
It's great. It's so good. So good for, you know, well, on every level. Just fantastic the way Australia's just fallen in love with this team.
There will be another release of tickets for people that missed out closer to the date. I suspect they'll be very few, and who knows how many minutes they'll last, but there will be one more chance if you did miss out. Let's get into a story that I think is going to irritate. Actually, irritate's not strong enough. Infuriate a large number of people listening this morning, and we've already received texts about it on the Dutton's text line. An Elizabeth Plains man has been sentenced to a partially suspended jail term of 6 months over a crash that killed a father of 5. Christopher Bennett appeared in the Elizabeth Magistrates Court to plead guilty for sentencing for the crash that killed Brad Thompson. You might remember this case. Brad Thompson was the motorcycle rider that was in the right, did nothing wrong, and was killed by Christopher Bennett. He entered guilty pleas to aggravated driving without due care, driving unlicensed, and also driving while under the influence of meth. Mr. Thompson was riding home from work when his motorcycle collided with Christopher Bennett's car outside the OTR at the intersection of Elizabeth Way and Phillip Highway at Elizabeth about 8:15 p.m. Now,
the other thing too, the magistrate said this, Magistrate Chris Smolich, if you had complied with your license disqualification and not driven, there would not have been a tragic loss of life. So he shouldn't have been on the roads. And also the magistrate you told police you were aware of the disqualification and that you should not have been driving. You had taken a longer route to the on the run to avoid police detection. So the only reason he ended up at the on the run, where he killed this bloke in the accident, was because he was trying to avoid the cops.
And he had some experience in driving without a license. And
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 times he'd lost his license. It's just extraordinary.
One of his sons entered a victim impact statement and paid tribute to his father, saying he was his best friend, his rock, and the family's big friendly giant. Most importantly, though, Dad, reading from the Tizer, he said, "This three-minute-long eulogy I read out right now poured out my heart and feelings, does not begin to scratch the surface of how much he truly meant to me and meant to my family, the man you took from us all." I don't know how you hear that. I don't know how you hear what the family said, and you hear all the evidence and the history, and in the end, this guy gets a headline sentence of 10 months, reduced to 6 due to his early guilty plea. He was then jailed for 3 months with the rest of his sentence suspended on a 2-year, $1,000 good behaviour bond. Good behaviour bond. 11 times disqualified.
There's no history of good behaviour in this man's miserable existence. Like, the guy is a card-carrying deadbeat. And, I mean, this is absurd. The idea that, you know, you bang the rights on all these counts, you're out there dodging the cops, And can I just interrupt myself? How desperately annoying is it that every couple of months we sit here having these frigging conversations and nothing changes?
Mm.
Like for Brad Thompson's family, like they must just be, I mean, you know, talk about the, what is it, the seven stages of grief. I don't know how you ever move past just red hot bloody rage about this, because this is the ultimate insult to not injury, but death. Like a good man lost his life at the hands of someone who's demonstrably an antisocial bludger. And the guy, with no alternative, he pleads guilty, so he gets half his sentence, which was, even in its fullest sense, I reckon a 10-month sentence for killing a bloke with five kids, is that's got to be unders, doesn't it?
It's pathetic.
But what, like, the actual parliament has the power. Malinowskis, Peter Malinowskis, you listen to our damn show. Kaya Ma, you listen to our show. Actually muscle up on this stuff. All we've had is tinkering at the edges.
Mm.
And for every parent teaching their kid how to drive, like the idea that you can just be like going past your local on the run and get cleaned up by someone who's, I mean, how old is Christopher Bennett? Like, what percentage of his life has he been driving unlicensed? He looks like he's about, I don't know, 30, 35? Hard to tell with all the meth he's been taking over the years, I guess. But what percentage of his adult driving life has he ever had a damn license?
It's a ludicrous scenario to think, even if you had a rule in South Australia where if you'd been done 10 times disqualified driving and you had a mandatory prison sentence at that point, there's a family of five that has a dad.
Yeah. But the thing is, like, it's not even 11 strikes and you're out.
No, been it's not. He gets to go again.
Yeah. Yep. It's just extraordinary. I, for the life of me, cannot understand a single word of this sentence. The other thing, too, the idea that Bennett, because you might remember, he did
the press conference.
He's the drip who did his star turn out the front. Yeah. I just want to say a few things. And he's standing there going, "I just, if I could replay that part of my life and bring him back, I feel so sorry. We should be thinking about a good man who lost his life." This sham contrition. For that family, for Mr. Thompson's family, watching this sham actor, ham actor, with his fake crocodile tears, and you know, if the magistrate has placed any store in what he said that day outside court, someone should sit him down and say, "Mate, have you actually seen the whole tape?"
Yeah.
Because I did, and there's one bit where a reporter, after he's blathered on for a full 4 minutes, a female reporter, and I emphasise female, politely tries to ask him a question, and he turns around and he looks at her and he goes, "I haven't finished yet."
Yeah.
Just swears at her, "I haven't effing finished yet." Like, you know, but I just feel like I've wasted 5 minutes of my life, though.
Mm.
Because what happens with all these things?
We get cosplay contrition and then they go about their business. Sean Fuster's coming up. We're going to go around the courts with Sean and we'll talk more about broadly about these sorts of issues after 7:30. You might have some thoughts, folks. We love to hear them. 8223 0000, or you can text us on the Dutton's text line 0448 08 1395. Let's check traffic. When the UV is 3 and above, cover up. Use sun protection. Stay sun smart. Download the Sun Smart app.
Thanks, Will. At Cowandilla, car and motorcycle crash at Donald Bradman Drive near Bagot Avenue. Works at Queenstown this morning, Old Port Road to Victoria Street, and slow for works at Coromandel Valley Main Road near Black Road. Starting to get busy south road at Thebes. No great surprises there, though. And we've got cameras at Beaverage Road, Ingle Farm, and Jeffcott Street at North Adelaide. It's Happy Days every Friday at IKEA. Head in store to get 50% off main dishes for IKEA family members. 11 a.m. till close every Friday at IKEA. T's and C's apply. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
5AA Mornings with Matthew Pantelis.
We've got this ridiculous policy on trading hours in South Australia. Should the shops have been open to give people that perhaps still don't have air conditioning somewhere to go and cool off? You know, you can come into the city and shop away, but you can't do that at Marion or TTP. You can at Mount Barker. I mean, it's so stupid.
Matthew Pantelis.
We've got to get on top of that at some stage, don't we? I mean, 2024.
Weekday mornings from 9 on 5AA. Always Adelaide.
At IGA, there's plenty of ways to save this Easter, like Cadbury chocolate blocks, 160 to 190 gram selected varieties, $3 each, half price. Now at your local IGA and shop online. Offer ends March 19. Participating stores only. Excludes IGA local grocer and foodland.
Ignition for Men, Adelaide's home of luxury menswear, offer an impeccable range of suits by leading Italian brands, including the unparalleled quality and style of Armani, Canali, Zegna, and more. Ignition for Men. What you wear speaks volumes about who you are and where you're going in the world. Make your mark with Ignition for Men. 54 Paynham Road, Stepney. Ignition for Men. Ignitionformen.com.au.
G'day everyone, Cornsy here. Now, I know a great team and I see one, and the South Australian hydraulic team I rate the highest is BL Shipway. I've known them for a long time. David Shipway is one of the best blokes you'll ever meet. BL Shipway, they've been looking after your hydraulic and pneumatic needs since 1953 with brands like Ryco, Rexroth, Enerpac, Hydec, Oilpath, EasyFit and many more. And if you can't get to them, they'll send a Ryco 24/7 van to you anytime, anywhere. blshipway.com.au, a South Australian team you can count on.
Join over 60,000 Adelaide homes and say yes to lowering your energy bills with Yes, your energy saving solutions. To beat the summer heat, Yes can connect you with a new air conditioner thanks to the SA Government initiative called REPS. Yes is offering eligible concession households a fully installed 2.6 kilowatt Rinnai system for only $899. Yes, $899. For T's and C's on this unbeatable offer from your energy saving solutions, go to yess.net.au.
Steinbrenner Automotive has always been well worth the trip. And now there's Barossa Mazda, Murray Street, Nuriapa. SA's newest Mazda dealership is now open. For 40 years, Steinbrenner has provided South Australians with outstanding customer service, exceptional value, and a large selection of new, used, and demo vehicles. The Steinbrenner story continues with the opening of their new, state-of-the-art Mazda dealership in Barossa Valley. Barossa Mazda. It's well worth the trip. BarossaMazda.com.au.
Rosanna Mangiarelli here from 7 News. Join me and Will Goodings for Adelaide's leading news hour, 7 News, tonight at 6 o'clock.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on, touch base, search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
28 minutes after 7, Footy Week, Crows and Port... this weekend, Port Adelaide Sunday against West Coast, Crows Saturday night against Gold Coast. Lots to talk about on the Sports Show with Rowie and Timmy G. $19 shindy Monday to Wednesday at the Birkenhead Tavern, Excelsior and Lighthouse Wharf. You just know it's a Borough Hotel. A lot of debate coming out of last weekend, though, has been around the AFL's approach to opening round, round zero, and some of the weaknesses of that model. Lots of people spoke to us about that yesterday on the program. Well, last night, Warren Treadray was on the Sports Show with his remedy for the AFL's round zero concept.
I thought if the AFL, and I get it wants to be standalone Sydney teams and Queensland teams, but why wouldn't you let South Australian teams, Western Australian teams play a part? Victorian teams don't travel as much. I thought it was a great idea, opportunity for that to happen, right? So, for example, if Port played Sunday night, well, that would tick the box. Every 4 years, Port, Adelaide, Fremantle, West Coast host. And even if we guarantee that we're playing the Western Australian teams, you're taking a team, Fremantle or West Australia, or Adelaide and Port Adelaide, when we either travel each other's states, we're not a huge pulling travelling team, are we? We're not big. We're not Collingwood, you know, Essendon, Richmond, who've had, Carlton particularly, have had players who've gone from Stephen Kernahan at Glenelg to play at Carlton, and they've followed over to follow the Blues and never gone back to the Crows or Port or whoever, you understand? So for my bit was every 4 years you could rotate it, where Port hosts one with West Coast then hosts Port, right? And this is going to be around forever. Adelaide hosts one with Fremantle, Fremantle hosts one with Adelaide.
It would be a better model to get more teams involved in the whole thing, because it does feel, it would be... it'd be a weird feeling that half the league every year starts in 1 week and half the league starts in another week.
Yeah.
It'd be sort of a weird sort of phenomenon to have take place.
Well, I think particularly with the point you made the other day about, you know, Carlton playing again before the rest of the team.
Four teams will play twice before half the league's played once.
Yeah. You like the sort of totality of seeing round one and drawing some early conclusions about who's looking good and who's looking crap.
Yeah. It doesn't feel like the...
speaking of crap,
fan.
My God, the Dutton's text line almost exploded and people are just shaking their head at this. It's not just so much the judgment, it's the law.
Mm.
You know, we're not saying the magistrate is erred in law. We're saying
that the
law
is perfectly in keeping with the law.
Ridiculous.
Yeah.
So let's rewrite the bloody laws.
Mm. 5AA News time. We're going to chat with Sean Fuster and go around the courts next.
This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Partly cloudy and 33 today with the 7:30 news. I'm Graham Goodings.
Chipped windscreen? Complete Windscreens can repair it from just $99. Look for the big red koala.
South Australia is set for an economic boom, with China about to remove its crippling tariffs on wine. A final decision is expected in late March after Australia reached an agreement with China late last year to work towards ditching the duties placed on Aussie wine in 2021. Wine critic Ray Jordan says the industry's been struggling since then.
There's an awful lot of wine sitting in tank, especially in South Australia, which is the country's biggest wine-producing state. And a lot of it is, well, it's sitting there in tank. It's all gassed up. It's not going to go off. But, boy, there's a lot of wine to start moving very quickly.
A drunk driver has crashed into a road sign at Torrens Park overnight. Senior Constable Kimberly Broad says it happened on Belair Road.
Extensive damage was caused to the vehicle, but luckily there were no reports of injuries. So that driver was submitted to a breath test, and she's allegedly produced a blood alcohol reading of 0.175. So a 32-year-old woman from Morfett Vale, she's been reported for drink driving and issued with a 12-month instant loss of licence.
A report is being prepared for the coroner after a death at a southern suburbs beach. Mel Usher has the details.
An elderly man has died in a suspected drowning at Aldinga Beach. A group pulled him from the water around 3 yesterday afternoon, but he couldn't be saved. The scene playing out in front of the 79-year-old's wife. They had just celebrated 60 years of marriage. Police say there are no suspicious circumstances.
Cyclist Rowan Dennis will face court today for the first time, charged over his wife's death. Melissa Hoskins was struck by a vehicle allegedly driven by Mr. Dennis outside their Medindie home on December 30. Melissa was a world champion cyclist and two-time Olympian who retired from the sport in 2017, then married and had 2 children. Her husband has been charged with causing death by dangerous driving, as well as 1 count of driving without due care. A technical issue has forced the federal government to reissue visas to most of the 149 high-risk asylum seekers released from immigration detention. The original documents weren't valid, meaning charges against 10 of the former detainees have had to be dropped. Labor argues the problem dates back to 2013, but was only discovered in recent days. Immigration Minister Andrew Giles says the government's doing all it can to keep Australians safe.
This is an issue that goes back more than a decade. It's been identified and now has been resolved. Everyone now has a visa. Throughout this period, constant monitoring of everyone has been maintained. There's been no lapse in community safety in that respect.
There's a push to scrap set shift hours for employees who work from home. A Fair Work Commission inquiry has heard from key employer associations, which are calling for an end to clauses requiring those clocking on from home to work 9 to 5. They say awards need to reflect the changing environment and should not prevent staff making up hours at different points of the day. Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Colours, custom design, any house, any style. Gliderol Garage Doors, gliderol.com.au.
And now here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Graham. 41st and Port Adelaide has some selection dilemmas ahead of its season opener against West Coast on Sunday, with forward Ollie Lord out of the picture for the match with a cracked tibia and bone bruising. They'll also have to work out what happens with their midfield. Zach Butters, though, cleared to play with that ankle sprain. Well, a 20-year-old Italian has done what so many tennis players have found to be mission impossible, beat the legendary Novak Djokovic. The 123rd ranked Luca Nardi says he's stunned after sending the top seed Djokovic crashing out of the Indian Wells tournament in the third round.
An amazing feeling, you know. I couldn't even imagine to play a match against him, and now I also beat him, so it's such a dream come true for me.
Yeah, great effort. South Australia needs 9 wickets to finish off its Sheffield Shield season with a win against the top of the table Tasmania in Hobart. The home side will resume on day 3 at 1-8, still needing a further 316 runs to win. Meantime, Australia's record-breaking all-rounder Annabelle Sutherland has won the ICC's Women's Player of the Month award. Let's go to soccer, and Arsenal scored a critical goal in its knockout Champions League tie against Porto. Trailing 1-0 heading into the second leg, the Gunners found a goal in the 41st minute.
Lovely ball, here's Trossard, and Arsenal are levelling the tie. Beautifully worked and expertly finished, Leandro Trossard.
Yeah, it's going off there. Audio thanks to Stan Sport. The second half now about to begin. One other match on this morning with Barcelona 2-1 up against Napoli, giving them an overall lead of 3-2 on aggregate. And that's the 5AA Sport.
Thanks, Tom. Now checking 5AA traffic.
You park your car in the shade. Same goes for you. Park yourself in the shade. Be sun smart.
At Cowandilla, residual delays from early car and motorcycle crash at Donald Rabbit Drive near Bagot Avenue. Road place in use at St Mary's at the moment. South Road near Princess Parade. Speeds at 40. Busy for works at Dry Creek, the north-south motorway near the Wingfield Interchange. With cameras today, Trim Parade season and Valley Road at Hope Valley. Lunch is sorted with OTR sandwiches, salads and sushi for only $6 each every Monday till Wednesday. Limited time only. OTR. Making life easy. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
And now the 5AA forecast.
No better time or place to jump into Jayco than at Jayco Adelaide's brand new West Beach dealership.
Partly cloudy, 33 today. Tomorrow, a late shower or 2, 28. Friday, a possible shower, 28. And Saturday, mostly sunny, 31. Right now, it's 25 in Adelaide. More news as it happens on 5AA.
The biggest threat to your business isn't your competition. It's cybercrime. Cybercrime threats impacting Australian businesses, large and small, continues to grow year on year. One call to one solution will put your business in a safe place and save you from the devastating consequences of cybercrime. It's the smartest, most cost-effective business decision you'll ever make. Stay safe and protected. Get in touch with One Solution. OneSolution.net.au, a Platinum Telstra partner.
Tina. The Tina Turner musical is rolling into Adelaide next month. This heart-pumping production celebrates the inspiring life story of Tina Turner, the queen of rock and roll. Featuring more than 20 of her iconic songs, Tina is guaranteed to raise the roof at the Festival Theatre. Opens April 24. Book at Ticketek. It's simply the best.
When you're a market-leading builder, like Regent Homes, you never rest on your laurels. It's why Regent Homes is South Australia's only builder offering 3D virtual reality technology in their Envision Design Studio. At your first design meeting, you'll walk through your home in virtual reality. It's a wow moment, enriching your experience so you can make the right design choices from the start. Regent Homes. Innovative design. Elevated living. Visit regenthomes.com.au.
It's Edward from Edwardstown Mazda. The M event is on now. It's really big. So here's a big person to tell you more.
Thanks, Edward. He's right. Our once-a-year M event is on now and it's big.
How big?
Think huge M event factory bonuses plus a $2,000 trade-in bonus exclusive to Edwardstown Mazda.
Wow.
I know. The M event on now.
Now play that jingle sing, please.
It's gotta be.
Edwardstown Mazda.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube.
Live, local, this is 5AA, always Adelaide.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on, touch base, search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
21 minutes to 8. Brad Thompson was a father of five who was killed when he was knocked from his motorcycle by Christopher Bennett, a driver who had on 11 previous occasions been disqualified from driving. He, in court, pleaded guilty to a host of offences, aggravated driving without due care, driving unlicensed and while under the influence of meth. For all that and the tragedy visited on that family, he received a three-month jail term with the rest of his sentence suspended on a two-year, $1,000 good behaviour bond. The headline sentence was 10 months. As you can imagine, our listeners are furious about this. Let's read some texts, because Sean Fuster's in the studio with us listening. We've got his take, because no one's covered more of these cases in South Australia than Sean. So let's read out what normal people think of this, and then we'll get Sean's expert analysis.
Justice system, what a joke. I'm 77. When I was 20, I lost my licence for 3 months, plus a fine for an unregistered trailer. Yep. Well, as I said to Will during the ad break, if you don't kill someone but you forget to register your car in this state, you pay $700 more than this bloke will under his good behaviour bond. Mm. Unbelievable. Stephen from Goor, echoing our call, where's the Parliament on this? Stephen puts it even more emphatically, where the F is the Premier on the issue? of this waste of space, driving disqualified 11 times. How long before this cretin's up to 12? We must stomp on these blanks from a great height. Please badger the Premier. Enough is enough. Wendy, David and Will, I agree with everything you've just said. Sick and tired of the results from the courts. This guy should be doing 10 years minimum. John in Normanville says, I'm so angry and disgusted. And I must say, I feel so powerless too over the sentence. How on earth can this magistrate be allowed to continue on the bench? Well, as we were saying before, we're not bagging the magistrate. No. We're saying the laws are stuffed.
Yep.
Maybe the magistrate could have gone harder.
But if it's 12 months and you automatically get a six-month reduction...
Bizarre.
Well, a 50% reduction for a guilty plea. It doesn't leave a whole lot of wiggle room. Let's get Sean on this conversation. I'm interested in his take.
It's time to go around the courts with Sean Fuster on 5AA Breakfast.
You can hear the frustration in our listeners, Sean, because we've had this conversation before. We've had it with you before. You've witnessed it over decades in the courts. I mean, I don't know what you can say, but what can be done? This is in the past, this case now. What can be done? Can anything be done?
Well, just have the dump button ready, because I'm probably going to need it over the next couple of minutes, to be quite honest. Look, first of all, condolences to the family who have lost a loved one who now have to kick on without a core member of their family because of this situation. Secondly, to both of you and to everyone out there, we're not bagging the magistrate here, because the magistrate has acted within the law. So everyone out there that says, how can this magistrate continue on? Whether we like it or whether we don't, the magistrate has done the right and lawful thing, to coin a phrase, underneath the legislation of this state. It is the legislation that is completely and utterly dump-buttoned. 100% dump-buttoned. Regardless of what anybody out there has been trying to say, this legislation has been fully dump-buttoned for decades. Mm. Because you have a situation right now in this state, and have had a situation in this state for decades, where if you are found guilty or plead guilty to causing death by dangerous driving, you face a maximum 15-year prison term. The next offence available is aggravated driving without due care, where the maximum prison term is 12 months. Now, we all know how functionally enumerate I am, but that is roughly 90 to 93% of a reduction in potential sentence. There is a gulf between those two offences. Following the Sophia Naismith tragedy, the state government tried to create an infraction in between those two things. We have yet to see one of those come through the courts. So, to be advised on what happens there with that new legislation.
So this was in the courts before this particular case, before that legislation went through.
Well, this person wasn't charged with that. This person was given the downgrade from the big to the small.
Yeah, okay.
There's supposed to be an offence in the middle that catches that. So the first question is, why did the DPP choose not to, or the SA Police, whichever prosecuted this matter, choose not to go with that mid-range offence? Number one, does that mean that that piece of legislation is actually worthwhile? Or was it just created to shut things up after Sophia's tragic death?
Mm.
Number two, on top of all that, would a magistrate or a judge use it? Because there is a decision from years and years ago called Queen versus Payne. Jared Payne was a driver who went through two red lights by using the right-hand turn lane as an overtaking lane around paused traffic. Mm. The third time he tried to do it, he struck and killed the car containing the Ralph family. Abigail Ralph died. Abigail's sister Lauren and her family have gone on the rest of their lives having lost Abigail. It's a trauma that they never get over. They have campaigned tirelessly for changes to the law, because when Payne was sentenced, it was a low sentence. The government challenged it at the time, and the full court of the Supreme Court said, you cannot set a tariff for driving cases. Every case is individual and must be judged on its individual merits. That prompted the government to do things, successive governments in fact, to do things like maximum sentences of 15 years, but every judge will, quite correctly under the law, say, well, yes, that's the maximum, but Queen versus Payne says I have to judge everything on its own merits. So we've seen situations where people have killed someone who was waiting to turn right because they were watching a wrestling DVD on their own in-car dash and not necessarily get prison time. The worst one I've ever seen, I'll never get over this, in a 24-hour space, in two courtrooms next to each other, in courtroom 9 of the district court on a Monday, I watched a kid who had a head full of cannabis, killed his best mate up against a tree, go to jail. The following day, next door in the next courtroom, I saw a kid who had a head full of Xanax and illegal drugs so bad that he didn't remember the preceding 3 weeks to the crash, kill his best mate up against a tree, and get a suspended sentence.
Well, how does that work?
What was the distinction?
You tell me. To this day, I don't know the distinction. To this day, I don't understand. This is why the advertiser has repeatedly over the years run the Road to Justice campaign to try to make people understand that the sentencing in this area is wildly inconsistent. Mm. Lee and Lynette Lyle, people I've known for years, their two children died in the same crash. That driver was, instead of being done for death by dangerous driving, done for aggravated driving without due care, and he walked. Walked on a suspended sentence. Two deaths.
It feels to me like there's two separate issues here. There's one involving the ultimate case where you actually kill someone, but then there's a lower level but still hugely important issue about driving while disqualified.
Absolutely.
And the number of opportunities this guy has been given to keep doing it. Now, I think apart from a couple of mates of mine who, when they were young and stupid, got drunk, got done for DUI, lost their license for a few months when they were 19 or something, I don't know anyone now in my circle of friends who has been disqualified from driving.
And the thing is, you're not seeing it for alcohol more than as much as you're seeing it for meth now. That's the big problem.
Yeah. So, you know, I think most reasonable people would say, okay, maybe you can lose your license once. Perhaps you can lose it two times. I reckon after three times, something much more dramatic has to happen to you where, say, on the fourth time, if you were caught driving while disqualified, you just simply go to jail.
That's what the legislation says already.
Well, why isn't that happening?
Good question.
Why is that not happening?
That's an excellent question that I don't have an answer for. Every time someone is... If you sit in court...
Well, right, if the courts don't apply the law, and I know that we'll have all the tut-tutting from the eminent jurists about the suggestion that, oh, you can't interfere with the judiciary. Well, if the law specifically in black and white says you should go to jail for that, why not... Tie their hands and say you have to.
Well, you can't tie their hands because the High Court will come down and slap you, but it is a jailable offence. And every time you're sitting in court, so when I sit in court, you guys will read a story that I've written, but I've heard 15 cases before that and 15 after while I'm waiting. A lot of them are driving without due care, so driving disqualified. Every time someone is done for driving disqualified, the last thing the magistrate says to them is, do not drive until your disqualification period is over and your licence has been renewed. You have to physically go to Transport SA and renew your license. If you drive, it is a jailable offence. They're warned every time.
And well, yet the number of people, clearly.
Well, the number of people I see joke. Who actually breach that warning and then end up in jail is very small.
Well, they should. The other thing they should do, do they take their cars away as a matter of course? It should absolutely be mandatory that you lose your car. I mean, the cash-strapped state government, I mean, just looking at the other headline today, $100 million taxpayer bailout for cancer bunker. You know, what's going on down the road at the Semri. It would be a nice little learner for Stephen Mulligan if every single one of these drongos had their car taken off after the third offence and the government sold it and kept the money.
But then who have you left without a car? A wife, kids, family, partner, husband, parents?
But that's their problem.
Is it? Well, do they have to suffer for the sins of the other guy?
Well, yeah, because their idiot partner should have thought of that. Mm. I mean, you could say that about any category of crime. You could say, oh, you know, the problem with, you know, This murderer, we've got to think about the murderer's family. Well, maybe the murderer should have thought about his family.
You and I are going to have to differ on that one.
Well, I don't know. I mean, it just feels like it's one-way traffic.
At the end of the day, those people are victims as well. Murderers' families are victims as well. Abusers' families are victims as well. And drunk idiot drivers' families are victims as well because they're suffering too because they're living with the guilt of the fact that their drongo partner is responsible for a death.
Yeah, but from a personal responsibility perspective, the sob story for that, the blame for that part of it rests with the perpetrator.
But if that then causes further injustice to other people?
If you make your bed, you lie in it.
I'd argue they didn't make the bed. He did.
Well, exactly. So it's on him. It's not on the state.
But they end up wearing it.
Well, I don't know. If you take that to the nth degree, no one would ever go to jail because it's going to be hard on somebody.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
Hmm. Good chat.
Will's just sitting here watching the tennis game.
It is like the tennis, isn't it?
No, the whole thing just depresses me. I'm not going to lie about it.
Well, here's what's depressing. I could name all those cases to you off the top of my head. off the top of amazing, my head. Mate. No, it's not amazing. That's what lives in here because this hasn't been changed.
You know what I think? The separation of powers obviously makes the whole thing difficult.
Mm.
And these people are obviously very intelligent, smart. But I just think the thing that our listeners would struggle with hearing all that, and you said 15 cases, one side of the one that gets reported, 15 of the other. I think most people go, how do you sit there and see that happen all day and not want to be part of the solution?
Well, I am trying.
It's not your job. Yeah. Now, I get it. I get the separation of powers.
Now you sound like Daniel. Daniel constantly says to me on Just Lawful, but that's not your job.
Yeah.
And look, there's only so much I can do. All I can do is platform the voices of people that are trying to be heard. Mm. And that's what I try to do, because you've got Abigail Rouse family. You've got the Lyles. You've got all these people. You've got Chris and Roger McEwen, all these people who want this change. All you can do is keep platforming and hope that people be listened to. The fact that the Naismith family were listened to is phenomenal and great. More listening needs to be done, because this is happening far too much. There are far too many people affected by this, and there are ways to change it. One of the biggest things that should have happened way back when is when the government got the answer in the Payne case, and we were left with this lack of a benchmark. They should have taken it higher and further.
Mm.
But we now have to wear that. The fact that Abigail would now be a woman in her 30s, possibly with a family, and we are still hearing her name invoked in court as a justification for garbage sentencing.
Yeah.
Terrifies me.
Completely.
Yeah, it's a disgrace.
Terrifies me.
Read Sean's great work on the Robert Wayne Collins, the fraudster who managed to continue defrauding people whilst being incarcerated for fraud. It's a great story. It's a terrific read. Also, tune into Just Lawful, because you get a new series starting up this Sunday.
That's right. There is a sexual predator about to be back on the streets of Adelaide, if he isn't already by the time we talk about this. We're going to talk about why he's getting parole and who it says that he should stay in jail forever. We're going to talk about the very famous case of Adelaide's masked brothers.
Looking forward to it, Sean. Great analysis, as always. Great appreciate stuff. It.
Thanks, guys.
All right, let's check traffic. When the UV's 3 and above, cover up, use sun protection. Stay sun smart. Download the sun smart app.
At Cowandilla, residual delays from really car and motorcycle crash at Donald Bramble Drive near Bagot Avenue. Bit slow for works at O'Halla and Hill, Main South Road near Lander Road, speeds at 40. And we are sluggish for works at Jepps Cross this morning, Port Wakefield Road near Matthews Road. Busy Brighton Road, Brighton, with a camera at Montague Road at Paraka. The M event is on now at Paradise Mazda, with exclusive bonus offers up to 2K across the range. Make your move to Paradise Mazda. The Mazda people. Offers end Sunday. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
NRG Solar have moved to a new location. It's bigger and better, and their new warehouse is fully stocked with wholesale solar and battery equipment. So, if you're looking to save money on electricity and help our environment, don't wait. Visit NRG Solar at their new office on South Road, St Mary's, where every 3 customers refer someone they know, which means they must be doing something right. Call into NRG Solar at their new premises, 1275 South Road, or visit nrgsolar.com.au.
Before you do a thesis in dishwasher, depart on an oven odyssey, or make a pilgrimage up Mount Washing Machine. Just trying to work out what appliances to get? Drop into Adelaide Appliance Gallery. We're here to make your life easier. We've got the best advice, best appliances, and the best offers on SMEG. Save up to 15% with special discounts on fridges, cookers, dishwashers, and more. That's 15% off. Make your life easier with Adelaide Appliance Gallery, Paynham Road, St Peters.
Now, Toolkit Depot's exclusive 3-day Makita sale event starts this Thursday. Whether you're shopping in-store or online, don't miss out on incredible Makita deals.
Sign up for free as a TKD club or trade member and get double discounts on the entire Makita range, from power tools and outdoor gear to accessories, 12-volt, 18-volt, 40-volt, anything. Makita means double the savings for TKD members.
Plus mega Makita battery deals and exclusive offers across the 3 days.
Toolkit Depot's 3-day Makita sale event this Thursday to Saturday, in-store or online at toolkitdepot.com.au. Toolkit Depot, everything you need to get the job done.
You know, there's a really simple way to be sure the ham you're buying is made from Australian pork. You just look for a pink box on your packs. That way, you'll know the pork comes fresh from our farms.
And I'm shipped in from overseas!
Yep, a pink box on your pack also means the ham has passed Australia's strict quality controls. So your ham will taste great. So, for true Australian quality, just pick a pack with a pink pork logo. Thanks a lot.
If you need to fix your pipes, call Precise.
Call Precise.
If your toilet's blocking up, call Precise.
Call Precise.
If your lights aren't turning on, or your hot water is gone, or a plumber or an electrician, call Precise.
Precise.
Precise Plumbing and Electrical. Call 1300 700 200. That's 1300 700 200. Precise Plumbing and Electrical. Local and experienced trade specialists.
Or a plumber or an electrician, call Precise.
Call Precise.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube. Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on, touch base, search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
4 to 8, Jay Broppin out the road for us, thanks to Dutton's, Big Ten Ford, GWM Havel, Hyundai, Isuzu, Ute, Mazda, Mitsubishi, Nissan, Ram, Subaru and Volkswagen. Dutton's, easy to do business with. Good morning to you, Jade.
Good morning, everyone. I've arrived to a suspicious house fire on West Street in Torrensville. Now, the fire, it's still smouldering from the roof. There's smoke billowing from the roof there, the roof cavity, and that's around 10 hours later. The fire, it's ripped through the back of the home here, and it's pretty much gutted the whole rear of the home. Now, the owner, Rosemary, was home at the time with her pets, and thankfully, they all got out and are safe and sound. The fire, it started around 10 o'clock last night. Now, multiple calls from neighbours in the area made the call to the MFS, and 6 fire trucks and 22 fireys were deployed to fight the fire. It took a couple of hours to bring it under control. Now, the damage bill, it's estimated to be around $350,000. Now, we're not sure if Rosemary is covered by insurance. It is a duplex home. The home next door has thankfully been saved, but the cause of the fire, it is suspicious. Interestingly, there is a security business directly across the road with a lot of CCTV cameras around it, so I don't think it'll take long before they'll find out who is responsible for this. But Rosemary, the owner, she's staying with her neighbour who lives just a few doors down, Clive. I spoke to him a short time ago. Clive, what happened last night?
I really don't know. Sometime around 10, but I'm not sure exactly when, I found some, saw fire engines in the street, or heard fire engines in the street. Other than that, I really can't say very much.
And you know the owner of the home. How's she doing?
She's extremely upset.
Has she told you how she was woken up to the fire?
Not really. So she just said she saw flames coming down the hallway.
She's staying with you. She's obviously a dear friend, a lovely woman.
We've known her basically since she moved in. Yeah, she is a friend.
So how long do you reckon the fireys were here for? I mean, they're estimating $300,000 worth of damage. Sounds like a big one.
The fireys must have been there for a couple of hours, but I mean, obviously most of that time they weren't putting it out, but investigating what had happened.
Anything like this happen in this area before? Has anything happened to the owner of the home before?
Nothing like this, no.
Just shocking. Incredibly difficult time. Thank you, Jade. It's a wonderful report. Great insight. Appreciate it. Let's take a break. 5AA News is coming up. Breaking at 8, not too far away. David Kosh is going to join us in the next hour of the program as well. When will interest rate cuts start filtering through? What's the RBA's thinking? Koshy's been poring over all the data over the course of the last week, and we'll get his thoughts in just a moment.
For over three decades, Regent Homes has been synonymous with crafting architecturally bespoke homes, each one a testament to Regent Homes' unwavering commitment to design, quality and sophistication. And because Regent Homes is a South Australian family-owned company, they understand more than anyone what it takes to build a family home. Experience Regent Homes' award-winning display homes at Lightsview and Blackwood Park. Innovative design, elevated living. Visit regenthomes.com.au.
Hi, it's Callum Hand here, ambassador for Pick a Local Pick SA. Right now, our growers in the Adelaide Hills are picking new season sweet, crunchy apples and pears and delivering them fresh to your local fruit and veg store. South Australian apples and pears make the perfect addition to your next cheese board or enjoyed as a healthy snack. Support our local growers and shop in stores displaying the red Pick a Local, Pick SA sign. And follow us on Facebook for inspiration, recipes and more ways to enjoy South Australian grown.
Imagine bouncing out of bed in the morning, brimming with energy, and all before your first sip of coffee. New Caruso's Vitamin K2 and Ubiquinol is a game-changing formula with two powerhouse nutrients to support your body's energy production and energy levels and maintain the health of your heart. Caruso's Vitamin K2 and Ubiquinol is made in Australia, comes with a money-back guarantee, and is available from leading pharmacies and health stores. Always read the label and follow the directions for use.
The very latest news and information. This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Partly cloudy, 33 today with the 8 o'clock news. Good morning, I'm Graham Goodings.
From chips to replacements, make Complete Windscreens your insurer repairer of choice. CompleteWindscreens.com.au.
South Australia is said to be the big beneficiary when China drops its crippling wine tariffs later this month. There are huge quantities of wine sitting in storage, particularly in SA, which is the nation's biggest wine producer. China was Australia's biggest wine market, worth more than $1 billion in 2019. Premier Peter Malinauskas has welcomed the news.
When the tariffs were imposed, South Australian wine exports to China went from being worth just shy of $1 billion down to a $3 million. That's a big hit. And that's money coming out of the pockets of hardworking people and businesses in our state. So by choosing to engage in a principled way, we've been able to get a good result here, and hopefully it becomes a final decision before the end of this month.
A duplex went up in flames at Torrensville last night. When fire crews arrived, smoke was billowing from one side of the West Street property. Senior Constable Kimberly Broad says the occupants managed to escape.
Damage was caused to the adjoining premises, but thankfully there were no reports of injuries. So we had fire corps investigators attend the scene to gather some evidence, and patrols door knocked the area. But we do believe that the fire may have been deliberately lit.
Another house fire in Albert Street at Kilburn last night is also being treated as suspicious. It caused about $300,000 damage. And a BMW sedan was set alight on Wolseley Terrace at Ascot Park early this morning. The vehicle has been completely destroyed. More than 80,000 students in SA will sit NAPLAN tests from today. Education Minister Blair Boyer says it's being held a bit earlier again this year.
This is the second year that we have had the test brought forward nationally to March. It was previously later in the year, and we've done that to make sure that we get the results from these tests earlier in the year. So if it does show that we need to put more support or focus in some areas, we could do that.
A legal bungle could see 10 former immigration detainees who breached visa conditions walk free. Labor's newly implemented monitoring measures have been rendered invalid due to a previous government law. It effectively means none of the accused men technically hold visas to breach, making way for charges to be dropped. The United States will send a new military aid package for Ukraine worth $300 million. The emergency support announcement comes as $60 billion worth of American aid is tied up in Congress. National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan says it's not anywhere near enough to help Ukraine defeat Russia.
This ammunition will keep Ukraine's guns firing for a period, but only a short period. It is nowhere near enough to meet Ukraine's battlefield needs, and it will not prevent Ukraine from running out of ammunition in the weeks to come.
Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Gliderol Garage Doors, adding strength, style and safety to your home. Gliderol.com.au.
And now here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Graham. Adelaide's selection panel will be keeping a very close eye on veteran Taylor Walker when he trains at West Lakes this morning. The 33-year-old has had some back issues in the past week, restricting him to light duties, but it's hoped he'll still be okay to tackle Gold Coast in the club's season opener on Saturday night. Well, a stunning display from Australian all-rounder Elise Perry has helped her Royal Challengers Bangalore to a 7-wicket win against the Mumbai Indians. Perry becoming the first ever player in the WIPL to take 6 wickets, finishing with staggering figures of 6 for 15 from her 4 overs.
Oh, she's close! Is that 6?
Amazing scenes, audio thanks to Fox. Chasing 114 to win, Perry then made 40 not out to help guide her side home. What an embarrassing night for the Western Sydney Wanderers in the A-League after they were humbled 7-0 by Melbourne City. Coach Mark Rudin refused to show up for his post-match press conference, leaving assistant JP Demarigni the awkward task of dealing with reporters.
Is he all right?
He's fine.
He's fine. So how come he hasn't rocked up? I think it's a pretty poor look.
Mate.
I've got no comment about that. I'm here to answer questions about the game. So if you've got that, I'll respond to it. If you don't have it, I'll move on.
Marco really should be here answering.
Meantime, Arsenal is still 1-0 up against Porto in its Champions League match with the knockout tie all square at 1-1 on aggregate. There's about 20 minutes to play there. To tennis, Stefanos Tsitsipas has been knocked out at Indian Wells in the round of 16 by Jiří Lehečka. Aussie Alex de Minaur faces Alexander Zverev in a match which is due to start shortly. And Aussie Tyler Wright has moved into the semi-finals of the Portugal Surf Pro. And that's the 5AA Sport.
Now checking 5AA traffic.
You park your car in the shade. Same goes for you. Park yourself in the shade. Be sun smart.
Morning, there at Cowan Diller. Residual delays from a car and motorcycle crash. That's on Sedona Rapid Drive near Backett Avenue. Roadworks continuing at Dry Creek today. The north-south motorway near the Wingfield Interchange. A bit sluggish at the moment at St Mary's. Road plates in use there. South Road near Princess Parade. Speeds at 40. Busy Brighton Road, Brighton with a camera. War Memorial Drive in North Adelaide. The Harvey Norman 2023 TV and soundbar run-out sale on Sunday. Don't miss clearance prices across the 2023 TV and soundbar range. And Sunday at Harvey Norman. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
And now the 5AA forecast.
No better time or place to jump into Jayco than at Jayco Adelaide's brand new West Beach dealership.
Partly cloudy and 33 today. Tomorrow a late shower or 28. Friday a possible shower 28. And Saturday mostly sunny 31. Right now in Adelaide it's 25. More news as it happens on 5AA.
Due to thermal expansion, the Eiffel Tower can grow 15 centimetres taller in summer. You can harness the power of the sun too this summer with a 200-watt solar mat from Aldi for $229. Portable, easy to use and ideal for camping, it's special you can buy at the Aldi Camping Essentials Sale this Saturday. Range differs between stores while stocks last. Aldi. Good. Different.
It's Edward from Edwardstown Mazda. The M Invent is on now. It's really big. So he's a big person to tell you more.
Thanks, Edward. He's right. Our once-a-year M Event is on now and it's big.
How big?
Think huge M Event factory bonuses plus a $2,000 trade-in bonus exclusive to Edwardstown Mazda.
Wow.
I know. The M Event on now.
Now play that jingle sing, please.
It's gotta be.
Edwardstown Mazda.
Streaming live via the 5AA Player app on DAB Digital Radio
and on 1395 AM.
This is 5AA, always Adelaide.
Ray White Business Sales, business people.
The powder finger to lift the mood. It's been a heavy half hour or so.
It's been heavy going this morning, hasn't it?
You know, you play the hand that's dealt, don't you? And I think, you know, judge from what everyone's saying on the Dutton's text line and the calls that we've had, people are just so fed up with talking about this. And you're the sort of hangdog tone you rightly had at the end of that chat with Sean, I think, reflected community sentiment, mate.
Yeah, which the whole thing's just depressing.
Yeah. It's almost like talking about American gun laws or something.
It's our version of American gun laws. Yeah. Is driving disqualified and killing people.
Yep. And these are the same drongos that go down your street at 80 kilometres an hour in the middle of the night.
Yep. Not going to change the way the law currently is.
Chucking burnouts when you go down to on the run to buy a carton of milk and there's some jerk in his car carrying on like a big he-man. Drives you mad.
Lots of Dutton's texts. We apologise to us we're not going to get to, but your texts, we read them all, and they certainly inform the discussion. Big Ten, Ford, Jeddah, Havel, Hyundai, Isuzu, Ute, Mazda, Mitsubishi, Nissan, Ram, Subaru and Volkswagen. They're Dutton's, and they're easy to do business with.
Give us the tea, Adelaide.
It is a Wednesday morning, though. You get caught out in the short weeks. We're already at Wednesday, which means it's time for some rumours. We have a Smeg...
Look at it.
Blender to give away.
Superb. I was in there at the Debney Display Centre last week getting the training for my new Smeg oven, which arrives next week.
If you are building or renovating, your first choice should be doing as David did and visiting the Smeg showroom at Debney Distributors. Taste the difference with Smeg. If you've got a rumour for us, now's the time to call. You can remain totally anonymous. 8223 0000 is the number to call. whatever it might well be.
Big or small?
Big, small, national, or uber local, whatever it might be.
Frivolous or momentous?
Yeah, that's right. Mm. It can be a bit of fun, or it could be deadly serious. We love to hear it, and Sam and Lisa will make sure you remain totally anonymous in the process. It's time for Breaking It Out.
Well, city retailers have had an absolute gutful with the ongoing, and they say continuing, spate of shoplifting. We saw an appalling new development on that front only 2 days ago when a female employee at Rebel Sport was knocked out with a stool by a 15-year-old girl who mercifully was denied bail when she appeared in the youth court yesterday.
Albeit she was out on bail when she did it.
Correct. Yeah. So it's sort of like double jeopardy in a way, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, one of the world's best-known sports brands and the owner of its iconic Adelaide store, the flagship Nike store in Rundle Mall, Shannon Aistrope, has been spending a lot of time, too much time, talking about this issue with fellow retailers in the mall, and he's decided to go public. And this is big because normally businesses keep their head below the parapet, but Shannon has had enough. I had a long chat with him yesterday, and he joins us this morning for this special Breaking at 8. Shannon, good morning, mate, and good to be talking to you again. I think the thing that surprised me and depressed me most about our chat yesterday was your sense that what happened at Rebel Sport on Monday was not even remotely surprising.
No, it certainly wasn't an isolated incident. Probably the last couple of years we've seen a significant increase in theft, violence and threats against staff, customers and patrons, and it's not just in my store but in the mall. We can see it's certainly not an isolated event.
What do you put it down to? Because some of it seems to be kids who are, well, young people, adolescents who almost operate as gangs. Some of it seems to be meth-related. How would you define it yourself?
Yeah, absolutely. It's a combination of both, to be perfectly honest. But I think there's been a dramatic increase in the gangs and the youth, like only on the weekend alone. I went into the store, actually on my day off, and to drop something off, and I saw a gang of youths walk in, and it was 42 degrees. You know, the kids are wearing three jackets. They're wearing masks. They're wearing sunglasses. They're wearing hats. It's just basically to be away from our surveillance, and they're there to cause chaos. They split up. They try to they harass our staff and our customers. And you know, when I confronted them, I asked them to remove it and say, "Look, guys, you know, it's 42 degrees. There's no reason for you to actually be here. I certainly don't think they're there to shop. They're there to harass and cause mischief and steal and aggravate the patrons of my store and run them all."
How often would you have a shoplifting, do you think?
Probably every. We have an attempt shoplift probably every second day at least.
Yeah. So attempt means
it's more prominent. It's more prominent. Oh, sorry.
Attempt means they get caught, I imagine. What happens when they get caught?
Yeah, majority of the time we catch them, absolutely. We have pretty good training and surveillance within the store. But unfortunately, I'm a family-owned business and I don't have the funds to have a 24/7 security. Yeah. So my team is, you know, there's a lot of costs that are going up through businesses. So we obviously try to keep our costs down to a minimum, but you know, security is a premium, and we try to balance our rosters with, you know, certain staff, and myself and my business partner quite often we work in security on Friday nights. I have staff now that are concerned working Friday nights. They don't want to work then because of the incidents. Predominantly Friday nights, in the traffic in the mall, I honestly believe dropped off considerably as a result of these gangs. And it's not just theft; they're loitering around. I witnessed probably 2 weeks ago when I was on security on the Friday night, these gangs of youths were actually forcing children that were 8 and 10 years of age, forcing them to vape. I don't know where those kids, the parents were of those children, but they're forcing them to vape in Rundle Mall. Now, for my own safety, I certainly didn't confront them, but, you know, I certainly didn't agree with it. But it is a significant problem that I'm not really sure that the government's really aware of how bad it actually is.
Shannon, you told me about an incident on Boxing Day where you confronted a shoplifter who was armed with a knife.
Yeah, that's right. I had a gentleman on Boxing Day that stole from us, and I'm actually a paramedic as well, so I actually have dealt with many of these people, you know, through that sort of walk of life. That I actually asked to check his bag, and I wasn't checking in the suitcase that he had full of clothing. I wanted to check his handbag, and he actually had a knife. And when I confronted him and asked him, "Can we check his bag? Because we believe he's stolen from us," he actually pulled a knife on me, and that obviously created an altercation between the two of us as I tried to protect myself, and he bit me. Unfortunately, at that time, that was a very difficult situation for myself and my staff. They were quite traumatised by it, and I was obviously concerned for my safety that occurred in the store. My manager called the police, and unfortunately, the police, you know, whether it was resourcing or not, actually didn't attend the job, you know, which is quite frightening. And that's why I'm really concerned with the resources and the attention that this is actually getting in Runnymede.
What proportion of the time do police attend when you've had a shoplifting or attempted shoplifting?
Generally, they're actually pretty good. We have a pretty good relationship with them, but I'm not sure if it's a resourcing thing or not, or patrols, or, you know, Runnymede Mall's a busy place. We're certainly not the only retailers there, so they're probably busy with other incidents that are on the mall. But quite often they certainly follow everything up with us. They're actually pretty good.
Do you know, Shannon, has the Adelaide City Council been made aware of the concerns of retailers, and have they done anything to help?
I've actually rang the Adelaide City Council, and no one's rung me back. I rang them and Rundle Mall Management, and I've left them several messages, and no one's contacted me back. They need to be aware of it. I have a general concern. There's no point in us, you know, trying to attract the gather round, all the festivals, live and et cetera, and invite all the interstate and international tourists to our premium shopping district in Rundle Mall. You know, if we're going to have these youths and gangs and not have the security there, I think we need to come together in a collaborative manner. I think the state government needs to lead this with the key stakeholders of the Adelaide City Council, Rundle Mall Management, key retailers, SAPOL, and actually come up with a strategic plan, work in a pragmatic approach to actually reduce this and make sure that our customers are safe, the patrons are safe, the interstate visitors are safe, and, you know, it's a great shopping experience, because I honestly believe that it's having an impact, particularly on Friday nights in Runnymede Mall.
Well, do you think there's a danger, Shannon, that some of the businesses there will just choose not to open on Friday nights in future?
Possibly, and I think there's other retailers that I've spoken to that want to take things into their own hands, which is a recipe for disaster.
Amazing. Great to chat to you again, Shannon, albeit on such a bleak topic. Shannon Astrup, the owner of the Nike store in Rundle Mall. Thanks for joining us for Breaking at 8. What about you ring the Adelaide City Council about the fact that your flagship sports store in Rundle Mall is besieged by violent shoplifters and they don't ring you back?
Can't even call back.
They've got a bit on their plate stopping kids from playing sport in the parklands,
yeah,
haven't they?
Yeah, someone somewhere might be trying to use the parklands to have a good time. So, priorities.
Correct.
Hopeless. Absolutely hopeless. 18 minutes after 8, we're getting some good SMEG rumours coming through. We'll get to some of those in just a moment. 8223 0000 is the number. David Kosh coming up shortly as well. But let's check traffic first. When the UV's 3 and above, cover up. Use sun protection. Stay sun smart. Download the Sun Smart app.
Thanks, Will. In the city, smash on Grenfell Street near Frome Street. Works a bit slow at the moment at Queenstown, Old Port Road near Victoria Street. Speeds at 40. Also a bit sluggish at Old Noolunga, Victor Harbour Road near Main South Road for works. Getting busy Brighton Road, Brighton, with Cumbers Days Road, Ferrodon Park and Main North Road at Paraka. What's better than a lounge sale? The Amart lounge sale. Save 20 to 50% off all lounges, sofas and recliners with over 2,000 designs to choose from. Shop in-store or online at Amart, Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
The 5AA Sports Show. Stephen Rowe and Tim Jennifer.
AFL opening round. Did you like it?
It particularly favoured the clubs that are playing at home, like the Gold Coast Suns, who play the Crows there this weekend. So they had a first lick at it, the ice cream. Now they get to play home again. I just think it's another compromise to the whole comp.
How do you know what round one is?
The 5AA Sports Show.
Because that's not round one.
No, round one's this week.
Oh, no. It's just ridiculous.
Weekdays from 4 p.m. on 5AA. Always Adelaide.
Thinking about a solar battery? Don't wait. Connect with NRG Solar and bring home a solar battery with a rock-solid 10-year warranty. Use the energy you generate during the day. Store some for later, reducing reliance on energy providers and putting money back in your pocket. See NRG Solar in their new premises at St Mary's. Bigger place, better space, some amazing people. Visit NRG Solar now at 1275 South Road or call 1300 858 160.
Before you do a thesis in dishwasher, depart on an oven odyssey, or make a pilgrimage up Mount Washing Machine.
Just trying to work out what appliances to get? Drop into Adelaide Appliance Gallery. We're here to make your life easier. We've got the best advice, best appliances, and the best offers on SMEG. Choose from SMEG's linear range of ovens and save up to $1,200 during the clearance sale. Make your life easier with Adelaide Appliance Gallery, Paynham Road, St Peters.
Now, Samtest Seafoods invites you to savour the finest seafood at unbeatable prices. This week, continuing their lowest king prawn prices in years. Indulge in raw king prawns from Spencer Gulf, starting at just $13.99 a kilo.
Experience freshness with the local baby calamari, $23.99 a kilo. And from the west, saddletail snappers, $15.99 a kilo. Plus New Zealand smoked mussel meat and brim fillet, both $14.99 per 500 gram pack.
But that's not all. Dive into our famous deal. 4 kilos of snap pros and seafood favourites for just $60. Mix and match your choices. It is an amazing offer.
Treat your family to premium seafood. Flathead, Dory, Emperor Barramundi, Atlantic salmon and more. All in their 4 kilo deal. Still just $60.
Crazy. Those prices haven't changed for years. Salt and pepper squid, gar, tempura battered NZ whiting, all included in the 4 kilos for $60 deal. Samtest Seafoods, our king prawn, freshly opened oyster and fresh seafood specialists.
Factory direct with on-site free parking, open 7 days too. Samtest Seafoods, where value meets quality. 201 Richmond Road, Richmond.
Xero connects me with all sorts of things for my business, like my bank, my apps, even my bookkeeper.
Numbers looking good.
That was my bookkeeper. Xero is business, but better. Try Xero free for 30 days. Visit xero.com.
Need a forklift? Don't just get a forklift, get a Toyota forklift. Toyota is the world's number one forklift brand, with a great range of pallet jacks, walkie stackers and reach forklifts, right up to their leading Toyota counterbalance forklifts. Legendary reliability and safety, with cleaner, greener electric options, Toyota can tailor the right forklift solution for you. It's all part of the Toyota forklift advantage. For more, visit toyotamaterialhandling.com.au.
Get a Toyota forklift.
Rosanna Mangiarelli here from 7 News. Join me and Will Goodings for Adelaide's leading news hour, 7 News, tonight at 6 o'clock.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on, touch base, search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast. And then
Koshy, good morning to you, man.
Morning, Will. Morning, Pembo.
I want to talk footy with you, Koshy. Of course, we've just had opening round, yep. Port's first game this weekend. But before we get to that, since last we spoke, in fact, I think it was the day after we spoke last week, the GDP data came out for Australia, which said we're still in this per capita recession. The economy only growing at the moment because we are importing so many people. What do you think that data set will do for interest rates this year? Does it move the needle at all?
It's certainly consideration for the Reserve Bank that meets next week. I know it's first Tuesday of the month, but sort of isn't the same anymore.
Yeah, it's harder now to keep track.
Since they changed the RBA board meeting date. That will go into the mix for the decision that they make next week. It will reinforce the fact that the Reserve Bank is doing exactly the right thing, keeping official interest rates on hold for the time being. Any more weakness in the economy, particularly that unemployment rate. Remember, it's part of the Reserve Bank's charter is employment. A lot of people forget that. Mm. So unemployment squeaked above 4% last month. Any new figures that come out that get it towards 4.5 or over, that will shift the dial the most in terms of a cut in interest rates coming through. But as we've seen in the US, they're now talking about interest rate cuts in June. Would you believe their economy is slowing down and their jobs market is weakening so much? So no change next week, but certainly I think the schedule is still second half of the year, maybe July, but more likely later in the second half.
That'll be music to the ears of homeowners around South Australia. Did you like round zero, Koshy?
I did. I did for a whole range of reasons. Remember, the reason for it is to focus on those northern markets, to give them a kick start for the new season, and I think it did that. The growth of the league, even though we're in a homeland traditional state, for AFL, the big growth is in New South Wales and Queensland. This year, there will be more kids or more people playing AFL in Queensland than South Australia for the first time ever.
Seriously?
Yep, first time ever.
Queensland?
Now, yes. South Australia is an issue in terms of it's lagging the country in terms of game development. So the AFL is very much aware of that and will have a focus on it. But because of the you talk about population growth in Queensland is enormous,
yeah.
and not so much in South Australia. I agree with your editorial in the last week, Tembo, that South Australia does have to grow. Adelaide's got to grow if you want to keep the standard of living that we've got now.
And the standard of footy, by the sounds of things.
exactly right. So, and... that leads to broadcast rights, that leads to more money in the game, or, you know, the ripple effect is huge. So to focus on New South Wales and Queensland, to give them that kickstart, because, you know, they had blockbuster games, so with how you run a club, if corporates want a box for that big opening round against a big team like Collingwood or Carlton, you go, well, you know, to get a corporate box for that game, you've got to buy five. And so it's a real shot in the arm for those clubs.
Absolutely. Well, mate, bring it on. It's going to be a big week, and you're going to be back here, on Sunday?
Yes, yeah. Come board meeting on Friday. Weekend, I don't know about you, but the start of the game is always nervous. I always fall for the optimistic comments of other clubs and thinking, oh, blimey, I didn't expect them to be competition, and will they or won't they? So it'll be put to rest starting this Sunday, so can't wait.
Absolutely. Yeah, no, well, all the best, Koshy, and we look forward to chatting to you next week after West Coast's miracle win.
Compare the market economic
that's
director.
A joke.
David Kosh.
$8.50 they're paying.
Yeah, no, I think Koshy's nerves will be calmed fairly early in that first quarter.
Probably
somehow
about 7 minutes in,
I reckon.
The Premier has been listening to our chat about Christopher Bennett and Brad Thompson, the father of five who he killed. Shall I save it for the other side of 8:30?
Yeah, save it. And
he
after
sent me
Fox
some interesting and thoughtful information, but he's been checking the background to the Bennett matter this morning, and he wants to share some information he has with South Australia through our program.
All right, that's coming up next.
The business sector has had incredible advances in AI. One solution can show you how AI can streamline your business, introducing efficiencies you never thought possible. You'll save money and time, unlock new growth avenues, and you'll be keeping up with the rest of the business community. With AI and One Solution, you can innovate, optimize, and excel across every facet of your business. One Solution will show you how. OneSolution.net.au, a Platinum Telstra partner.
Join over 60,000 Adelaide homes and say yes to lowering your energy bills with Yes, your energy saving solutions. Do you know how much that old fridge in the shed is adding to your electricity bill? Your energy saving solutions can collect your old inefficient fridges and freezers for free, and the best part is that you can also get up to $150 per unit. For T's and C's on this unbeatable offer from your energy saving solutions, go to yes.net.au. That's yess.net.au.
If you love your home but you've never been in love with your kitchen, well, the answer is not far away.
No, 15 minutes up the freeway, in fact, because that's where you'll find Bauhanna Kitchens by Design. They boast the largest kitchen design showroom in the hills, and more importantly, it's a family business with 35 years' experience, so they care about taking care of you.
And their expertise goes further than kitchens. They can create laundries, linen cupboards, robes and vanities, plus all cabinet installations are backed by a 10-year warranty.
Bauhanna Kitchens by Design. It's not too far to go to make your dream kitchen a reality. See more at their website, bauhannakitchens.com.au.
Make your move into a new Mazda at the Mawson Lakes Mazda M Event. From March 12 to 16, enjoy an M Event bonus of up to $2,000 off a wide range of 2023 plated Mazda models, including the CX-3, CX-30, CX-5 and VT50. Head to Mawson Lakes Mazda for the M Event and make it yours while stocks last. Salisbury Highway, just a short drive from the city. Terms, conditions and exclusions apply. See mazda.com.au for details.
This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Partly cloudy and 33 today with the 8:30 news. I'm Graham Goodings.
Chipped windscreen? Complete Windscreens can repair it from just $99. Look for the big red koala.
China imposed tariffs on Australian wine may be removed within weeks. The tax impost hit the wine industry in South Australia hardest, reducing our exports from $1 billion to less than $3 million. Beijing's review of the import taxes of up to 220% is expected to be finalised this month. The charges were imposed in 2020 during a diplomatic spiral between our countries. National Senator Matt Canavan says Australia has done nothing wrong.
Xi Jinping decided to become much more assertive, much more aggressive, took great umbrage at the Australian government having the temerity to say that we wouldn't allow Huawei to build our 5G network. Now, almost every other country in the world has made the same decision, but we were the first and we paid a price for that, but it was the right decision to make.
Police are investigating a suspicious car fire at Ascot Park this morning. A BMW sedan was completely destroyed by the blaze outside a home on Wolseley Terrace. Police are asking anyone who witnessed any suspicious activity or has information about the fire to contact them. Cyclist Rowan Dennis will face court today for the first time, charged over his wife's death. Mel Usher reports.
33-year-old Rowan Dennis has been on police bail since the death of his wife, Melissa Hoskins. She was struck by a vehicle, allegedly driven by Mr. Dennis, outside their Medindi home on December 30. 32-year-old Melissa was taken to hospital but succumbed to her injuries. Melissa was a world champion cyclist and two-time Olympian who retired from the sport in 2017. She married Dennis the next year, with whom she had two children. Mr. Dennis was arrested and charged with causing death by dangerous driving, as well as one count of driving without due care. Police will allege he drove recklessly or at speed or in a manner which was dangerous to any person, and by that culpable negligence, recklessness or other conduct caused the death of Melissa Marie Dennis.
Thousands of students across the state will be sitting their annual NAPLAN testing from today. The National Assessment Program, Literacy and Numeracy, will test the skills of around 86,000 students from state and non-state schools. Students in years 3, 5, 7 and 9 will be tested on their reading, writing, spelling, grammar, punctuation and numeracy. Bosses want to end the traditional 9-to-5 shift for people who work from home. They claim employers and staff shouldn't be prevented from reaching agreements that allow parents to make up their hours after their children have gone to bed. Brent Ferguson at AI Group says it's common sense.
At the moment, we've got these really archaic rules in some awards that say, you know, if once you start work, you've got to work continuously apart from your meal break. Now, that made a lot of sense when you were bringing employees into an office or a workplace, but it just doesn't match with the realities of what people want to do when they're working from home.
The life-size hyperreal sperm whale that first appeared on Saturday morning at Glenelg Beach drawing crowds of over 100,000 is on the move. The theatre piece, created by Belgium-based group the Captain Boomer Collective and part of the Adelaide Festival, delivered a powerful statement about the environment and climate change. The whale is being moved today to Elder Park next to the Torrens River and in front of the Adelaide Festival Centre. Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Colours, custom design, any house, any style. Gliderol Garage Doors, gliderol.com.au.
And here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Graham. Let's start with footy. Port Adelaide's players will hit the training track this morning as they prepare for Sunday's season opening clash against West Coast at Adelaide Oval. The Power are heavy favourites to win the match, but Chairman David Koch has told David and Will he's always a little nervous heading into round one.
I don't know about you, but the start of the game is always nervous. I always fall for the optimistic comments of other clubs and think, oh, blimey, I didn't expect them to be competition, and will they or won't they? So it'll be put to rest starting this Sunday, so can't wait.
Yeah, bring it on. Koch will be in town for a board meeting later this week ahead of that clash against the Eagles. The Crows will also train this morning as they look ahead to Saturday night's difficult road trip against Gold Coast. Adelaide to keep a close eye on Taylor Walker this morning, who's recovering from back spasms. Let's go to tennis. Aussie Alex de Minaur has just hit the court in his round of 16 clash at the Indian Wells Masters. He's taking on 6th seed Alexander Zverev. It's still very early in the match with games on serve at 1-1 in the first set. And in some soccer, Arsenal and Porto have just gone into extra time in their European Champions League knockout tie after it finished 1-1 on aggregate. The Gunners won this morning's match 1-0 at home, but they lost the first leg 1-0. Meantime, Barcelona has gone through to the quarterfinals after a 3-1 win against Napoli. And that's the 5AA Sport.
Now checking 5AA traffic.
You park your car in the shade, same goes for you. Park yourself in the shade. Be sun smart.
In the city, a smash on Grenfell Street near Frome Street, slowing things up. Activity at Queenstown making things busy too. Old Port Road near Victoria Street and slow going at Coromandel Valley for works. Main Road near Black Road speeds at 40. Getting busy, Brighton Road, Brighton with a camera, Frederick Road at Grange. At Bunnings, you can find everything you need to make a difference to your home for less. Make the most of Easter at your local Bunnings warehouse. Shop in-store or online today. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
And now the 5AA forecast.
No better time or place to jump into Jayco than at Jayco Adelaide's brand new West Beach dealership.
33 and partly cloudy today. Tomorrow a late shower or two, 28. Friday a possible shower, 28. And Saturday mostly sunny, 31. Right now in town it's 27. More news as it happens on 5AA.
When you're gone, who gets the things most precious to you? Like your highly valued comic book collection, or your 1976 Tirana in mint condition. If you don't have a will, you'll never know. Donlan Lawyers specialise in wills and estate planning. From the simplest to the most complex, Donlan Lawyers will give effect to your wishes. For wills and estate planning, visit donlanlawyers.com. Hindmarsh Square, Adelaide, and Ocean Street, Victor Harbour.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube. Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on, touch base, search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
23 to 9, we've got some SMEG rumours we're going to get to in just a moment. Building or renovating, your first choice should be visiting the SMEG showroom at Demi Distributors. Taste the difference with SMEG. We'll also be chatting with a winemaker in the next few moments about that really exciting news overnight, that an interim determination from the Chinese government has meant that the tariffs that have crippled the South Australian wine export industry have been lifted, and potentially it's $1 billion worth of exports that can return to the marketplace by way of China.
Fantastic news. While we were chatting to Koshy at the start there, I checked out of the interview because I was texting back and forth with the Premier. As I said, he was listening to our chat about the Bennett matter. And he says, look, there's some important info that you and your listeners should be aware of. He says, Bennett was charged with aggravated driving without due care. This is the same offence that Alexander Campbell was convicted of in relation to the death of Sophia Naismith, which led to law reforms by the Malinauskas government. Those reforms lifted the maximum penalty from 12 months to 7 years, but the laws came into operation on January 1, and the death in this case, the death being of Mr. Thompson, happened in November 2023.
Yeah, this is the question I asked of Sean. That makes sense.
So when, what he says, while it will be of little comfort to the family of Brad Thompson, the penalty has been increased, but not in time for Bennett to be charged under the new laws. So the maximum Bennett could have got under the old laws was 12 months. So, you know, we did give credit to the government for the work that it did liaising, we should stress, with the family of Sophia Naismith. But I did write back to the Premier saying there's still huge feeling about the strength of the laws and perhaps more so the application of existing ones relating to recidivist unlicensed drivers. And he said, look, yep, I totally understand. So that's something we'll continue to pursue, because I know there's people in the government who shake their heads about this as well.
Well, it'll be interesting to see that, as Sean said, no one yet has come under this new law. So when the first of those cases comes through, with the discounts and the approach to sentencing that exists, what does the headline sentence look like then?
Mm.
Hopefully it's something much closer to 7 years. Let's take some rumours. Red is on the line. Morning to you, Red.
Yeah, good morning. We're not under Russian rule, are we?
No, mate. No, I don't think so. No.
This is Russia. I just don't want to end up in the Arctic Circle, that's all. There is a strong rumour that I have a good source that the entertainment centre will be demolished. The government's still looking at a new site. I think that's the reason Enzo's has also departed with his lease on Port Road.
That's interesting.
Well, that would be a big story. So a new entertainment centre at another site. I wonder what they would use that site for.
I was going to say, they're not going to knock down the Channel 7 building too while they're at it, are they?
What's that?
They're not going to knock down the Channel 7 building while they're at it, are they?
No, that'll make it inconvenient for me. I like that drive up Grange
Road. You might have to speak up a bit while you're reading the news, mate. Good rumour.
That would be really interesting.
So imagine if they do knock down the entertainment centre, meaning that one of the key promises the Malinowskis government will make seeking a second term is they're going to build a new entertainment centre.
I think that's sounds like it might be on the cards. Good rumour, Red. Thank you. Let's go to Green. Good morning, Green.
Good morning, boys. Now, don't be alarmed. There's going to be a shortage of soda waters, mineral waters, tonic waters, anything that's made from carbon dioxide for the people playing at home, CO2. Now, the manufacturers cannot, or the manufacturer of CO2 cannot supply the companies. Now, the biggest manufacturer of CO2 is India, which manufactures 66% of CO2, and then you got, and that's in India, and then you got China and the UK. So there's going to be a shortage. You're going to see your supermarket shelves empty. Now, don't panic, buy. Leave some there for other people. But, yeah, it's filtering through, so those shelves are going to be empty.
Interesting. Good one, Green. Thank you for that.
Short of fizzy drink.
Yeah.
Yeah. Two good rumours there. So a bulldoze entertainment centre and a fizzy drink shortage. Keep them coming. 8223 0000. We'll give away that magnificent Smeg blender that you can see on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream before 9 o'clock this morning. We started the program talking about the very good news that broke just after 7 o'clock local time last night, that China had issued an interim recommendation abolishing tariffs on bottled Australian wine in October of 2020, if you go back to October of 2020, China was South Australia's largest export market, valued at $94.6 million, accounting for 47.2% of the state's wine exports. Huge market. How about this? As of November last year, with the full effect of the tariffs hitting hard, the value of that market became just $2.7 million. Gives you some sort of sense as to how big the news last night will be for the local wine industry. Mitchell Taylor is the winemaker and managing director of Taylor Wines and joins us on 5AA Breakfast. Mitchell, good morning to you.
Good morning.
This must be music to your ears, Mitchell, after such a punishing 3 years.
It is. It's a really good sign. While it's an interim recommendation, everything is very positive. I've just been up in Hong Kong, you know, preparing for this re-entry. And so, yeah, it's been a very tough 3 years for Australian winemakers. So we really do welcome this news and hopefully it'll be confirmed later on.
Yeah. Does the industry, do you have any sense as to how many people were displaced from working in the wine industry in South Australia, or did most wineries manage to scramble to come up with a plan B to keep sales at a level where they could keep their staff on?
Yes, I think most did. I mean, winemakers, we are in an ever-changing world all the time. It's quite a fashionable industry. So, yes, I think a lot, you know, there were certainly a lot of pain. You can see the pain in the growers and the price through. That's all ricocheted throughout the industry, and some people have been put off. So, yeah, it has been very tough. But, yeah, we're a resilient lot. I think Australian winemakers, we're always, you know, trying to be positive. So this is just the tonic we need going forward, you know, while we're going through vintage 20, 24.
We heard lots about diversification in the industry and having to find new markets, new export markets. That being the case, do you envisage that at any point in the future, China will account for a figure like 47.2% of South Australian wine exports? Will we get back there, or has the industry forever changed as a result of this?
Yes, I don't think we'll get back to that. China was booming back then. We were the flavour of the month. We've been out of that market now for 3 years. The French and the Chilean winemakers have a chance to build relationships. And remember, the wine industry is value-added. We manufacture, we market. So we're not a commodity that quickly switches from one market to another. It really takes us a lot of effort, a lot of shoe leather. We've got to go out, visit the customers, taste our wines, and build those relationships. So, it will take quite a big effort for the industry to start to reset. So it's a positive sign, but it won't be about turning a tap on and going back to the heydays of 3 years ago.
Do you think, in terms of going or trying to go back to those heydays, Mitchell, do you think that some wineries are actually going to be a little bit more reluctant to put all their eggs in the China basket a second time around?
I think so. I think a lot will want diversification. They'll look at all the Asian markets together, and they'll also look at, you know, opportunities here at home in developing markets here and also North America and the UK. So, yeah, I think you're right. But having said that, the beauty about the Chinese market is they've got very good palates. They like our very high-quality wine, particularly the red wines. They love our Clare Valley Shiraz, our Clare Valley Cabernet Sauvignons, and this is very good for the industry. This is really the sustainable, you know, high-end, luxury end of the market. So, we're really positive about this market. Showing great signs of reopening.
I'll tell you what, between COVID and the lockdown and interest rate hikes affecting people's disposable income, and on top of that, tariffs, I suppose the one good thing is you do work in an industry where you can have a solid drink at the end of the day.
you can. But even we even get nervous this time of year. You know, Mother Nature throws a few tricks. We had even a little bit of Jack Frost in our vineyards. So there's always an obstacle. But you're right, we do get really involved in our product, and we, you know, we love celebrating these moments and enjoying the fruit and the beautiful wines of all our labour.
Yeah, absolutely. Mitchell Taylor there, winemaker and managing director from Taylor's Wines. Great to have a chat with you, Mitchell.
Nice to have a good news story.
It is.
This morning as well.
Yeah.
Terrific news story for a really important South Australian industry.
Watch this space because there's plenty of other industries that have been affected, probably... I reckon in a sort of impact sense, lobster's probably copped it the worst.
In the southeast.
Yeah, yeah. We'll line up a chat with a Kingston lobster fisherman, angler.
I think it's all trending in a positive direction.
Feels like it. Although, you know, the thing is, though, what's the most likely dramatic headline involving China in the coming decade? It would be the annexation of Taiwan.
They've invaded Taiwan? Hmm.
Yeah.
So, and that would, you're right, that would, if you're framing that as a challenge for the South Australian export market.
Well, it's not fanciful.
No,
I mean,
no.
The whole, like, the, you know, things like the AUKUS deal, everything we're doing, you know, in the region is framed around Chinese belligerence. So we're not going to have the cojones to say, all right, we're declaring war on China.
No.
But the thing that would happen, the first thing would be trade, which is what happened with Russia after Ukraine.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, yeah, I think there's plenty of things on the horizon that are probably going to be even more unmanageable than ScoMo shooting off his mouth about where the coronavirus started.
It's not a transaction without risk for the foreseeable future.
It's not.
All right, let's have a look at the fuel situation, find out when fuel is at its cheapest and when to fill up nearby with the free RAA app. Here are some cheap spots we've been able to find. The United at the airport's at $1.715 this morning. That's about as good as you'll find it. Otherwise, you're looking at the OTR Glen Osmond Road, Glen Osmond, $1.75.9. The Caltex Montague Road, Modbury North is at $1.75.5. And the cheapest diesel is the Ampol on Main North Road, Paraka, at $1.86. 106.9. Let's check traffic and come back with Jade Robren, who has found the new location for the beached whale that showed up mysteriously on Glenelg Beach over the weekend. It's got a new resting spot, a bit further inland. Jade's there and with all the details shortly. Traffic first, though, when the UV's 3 and above. Cover up, use sun protection, stay sun smart, and download the Sun Smart app.
Thanks, Will. In the city, a smash on Grenfell Street near Frome Street, Croydon Park, current to a fence on South Road at Regency Road. Queenstown works there, Old Port Road near Victoria Street, and we're a bit sluggish at the moment, Old Nolunga, down to 40Ks for works, Victor Harbour Road near Main South Road. You find cameras on the driving today, Jeffcott Street, North Adelaide, Agronella 2 Valley Road at Hope Valley. The BMW sale event starts this Thursday. Enjoy savings equal to the GST on select BMW vehicles across the range. Visit your participating BMW dealer today. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Don't wait any longer to protect yourself or your loved ones with Care Alert GPS personal alarm. In an emergency, simply press the SOS button to call for help. Plus, an SMS with your exact location will be sent to your emergency contacts. Our advanced features include fall detection, and you can even speak through the pendant. And did you realise that your Care Alert could be free? For more info, contact Care Alert on 1300 75 85 95. Or visit carealert.com.au.
This is what it sounds like to win the Hospital Research Foundation Home Lottery. Speechless. The $3.6 million grand prize could be your new life at Henley Beach in a fully furnished Scott Salisbury dream home. Let that sink in. Homelottery.com.au. Join the fight and support life-changing medical research for all South Australians. License M14493.
Now, home maintenance can be exhausting. You need to know a plumber, an electrician, a handyman, and a renovator, or this makes perfect sense. You could swap all those numbers for just one Precise Plumbing and Electrical.
Simplifies things very nicely, from plumbing and electrical work to pipe relining, bathroom renovations, and handyman services. They're your one-stop solution. And they've got 25 years worth of happy customers.
Lovely bunch of people. They'll service all areas of Adelaide. They'll be there on time every time with an expert in your field of need, ready to do top-notch work. In fact, they are so confident in their expertise, their workmanship comes with a lifetime warranty.
Yeah, that says a fair bit. With free quotes and upfront fixed pricing, Precise Plumbing Electrical is a name you can trust and the only name that you need to remember. Visit preciseservices.com.au.
Get obsessed with the Honda SUV range at Formula Honda, Modbury and Glen Osmond. Whether it's the compact HR-V, the sporty mid-sized Honda ZR-V, or the spacious CR-V. And for a limited time, new Honda SUVs come with a 7-year warranty, 7-year roadside assist, and 5 standard low-price services at $199 each. Visit Formula Honda, Modbury or Glen Osmond and test drive today. Vehicles used for a commercial purpose have a 7-year or 200,000-kilometre warranty. Whichever occurs first. T's and C's at honda.com.au.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on. Touch base. Search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
7 to 9. Jade Robren out on the road. Thanks to Duttons in just a moment. But first, speaking of out on the road, Ian the Truckie's called into the program. Morning to you, Ian.
Good morning, gentlemen. I thought I'd like to just say, when's the last time we built a brand new jail, then changed the laws, and people that drink and drive without a licence have a mandatory sentence to go to jail, whatever that is, a month, 2 months, whatever. When are we going to start getting serious about these people and changing the laws and bring the road toll down? We keep doing the same thing and we keep ending up with the same situation like you guys have been talking about today.
Mate, I'm with you. I'm 100% with you, and so are a lot of our listeners. And I reckon, say third offence, even I think the amount of time you reference there, 1 month. 1 month would probably do it for most people. That would focus the mind.
You're twice the limit over the... Mate, you're going to jail. Just like they brought in the on-the-spot fines 40-odd years ago. You didn't have to go to court over every fine. You just got an on-the-spot fine. Well, you're going to jail right now for 1 month, 3 weeks, whatever it is. If you're three times over the limit, you're going to jail for 2 months, three months, whatever. At least there's going to be something to get the message out there. And then you think about it twice and you go, shit, if I have another drink, geez, I'm risking going to jail here. Oh, no, this is not, I'll do something different. Plan B. What do you reckon?
I like it. I like it. I mean, we managed to lock up the entire state for an illness which, in hindsight, has turned out to be as menacing as the common cold.
Mm.
So, you know. Yeah, good on you, Ian. Yeah, absolutely. I like it. Hey, sad news. Eric Carmen died over the last couple of days. He died in his sleep. It went peacefully. But I'll tell you what, a lot of women in particular, the Dirty Dancing soundtrack is right up there with the best-selling soundtracks of all time. Hungry Eyes became the anthem of Dirty Dancing. I reckon the most, like, if you had to do top 10 mournful torch songs of all time, it's almost like you'd say, all right, which one comes second? Because All By Myself. Ultimate karaoke tune too.
Absolutely. I think it's also, unfortunately, aptly describes Jade Robron out on the road this morning, who you can watch on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube Live. In fact, no, she's not. She's not all by herself. She's got a giant whale behind her.
A whale of a friend.
A whale of a friend. Usually you're all by yourself, Jade.
Normally, but no, I've got you guys with me by my side, but I am in Elder Park right now, and you will see on the live stream that we in fact have the whale that was famously placed on the beach over the weekend down at Glenelg. It has made its way to Elder Park, where it will be until Friday. It is a life-size hyperreal sperm whale. Now, it's a theatre piece created by Belgium-based group The Captain Boomer Collective, and it's part of the Adelaide Festival, delivering a very powerful statement. Joining me now is Bart. Bart, please tell us about this powerful message.
Well, thanks. And to me, the message that this magnificent creature from the deep brings is, I can't anymore. It's throwing itself at our feet. It's coming out of its element and saying, yeah, to us, like, yeah, what are you going to do? Because, the situation is pretty dire. On the other side, I mean, people can read into this what they want. It is an art piece, which means that if you want to see it as a confrontation with death or with otherness, that's fine. And we see that this installation plays out on very different levels, and everybody has their own experience and emotional journey going through this. We play a game between fiction and reality, which means that people sometimes change their mind, like it may be still real or not, and when they discover it's not real, their emotions shift, and that's what we think is interesting. Maybe you're relieved that it's not real. Maybe you're angry. Maybe you think it's funny. In all the tragicness, there is also a humor, because basically we're pranking people in an artistic way. So it's a very rich interaction we see here around this art piece.
100,000 people visited the piece of art down at Glenelg. A lot will come over here from today, tomorrow, and Friday. How did you move it here? It's huge.
It is huge, and all the credit goes to the Adelaide Festival. We've been trying to get this piece that means so much to us out of Europe, where it has toured in Paris and in Warsaw and London. But logistically and productionally, it's such a big challenge, and Adelaide Festival have been wonderful and working with us for a year. There's big logistics involved.
It is indeed. It is very big. And someone told me that you can almost, it's got a smell to it as well. Is that true, or am I just smelling the torrents?
No, you are smelling. You are indeed smelling a real whale, because I can let you in on one of our secrets. What you're smelling is partly, we used some real whale blubber to reproduce the smell, amongst other things. But to me, we just hyper really recreate a whale beaching in every detail. The fact that the media shows up is one of those things that always happen with whale beachings. But we just want to go at extreme lengths to do this, to recreate this spectacle. And what you see through the ages is that when a whale beaches in a community, it has always been a major event. the meaning has changed, but it has always brought people together and was always about, okay, our bond with nature.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so very much for sharing your thoughts. You can come down. We are just near the rotunda, and the whale, we'll have to come up with a name for the whale. It is down here. Willie the Whale will be down here until Friday.
Something to do and smell.
How'd they get into Australia?
Thank you, Jade.
Maybe they had to fly Virgin and list it as a comfort animal.
I think that's precisely what's happened.
That is awesome.
Yeah, it looks very cool. Thank you, Jade. We're out of time. Matthew Pantelis is coming up. We'll catch you tomorrow morning from 6. The blender goes to who?
The blender goes to Red. Well done, Red, for the entertainment centre rumour.
Building or renovating your first choice booze in the Smeg showroom at Debney Distributors. Taste the difference with Smeg. On 5AA Mornings today, hope on the horizon for wine.